New game. I have it as anything more than... I think I can. There we go. Ah, whatever. Yeah. Let's do that then.
So this is where the truck's heading straight at me. Should be about 30. I'll be hitting about 60. If the truck clips me, it's anybody's guess where it spins me.
So you have like 6 films to go through. It's quite fun. There we go. Nice. Ooh. There you go. Like, tell us about the game, so.
This movie's a gangster comedy. Two hopeless small-timers up against the police and gangland kingpin, the dentist. One of the leads, Vince, is trying to get across town for a pickup. But he's already late. I'll have constant radio communication with the director for every stunt I do. Time to get on set.
Here we go. I hope it all balls this up. Oh boy. I love how this is done though.
Toothless in Whopping, scene 4, take 1. Accelerate. 180 handbrake. Hit the boxes. Left into the tunnel.
Whoa, truck.
Overtake.
That apparently counts as a pass.
Through the gap. Hit the boxes. Through the gap. Hit the boxes. Brake.
Nice.
And cut.
100%. Sick. New car, new arena toy. No, new arena toy. Nice.
Because we're in Britain, the cars are right-hand drive, so we get left-hand drives over from Europe and drive those. We'll actually control the cars with mini steering wheels we keep out of shot.
Huh. Interesting to know. Yeah, how's everyone doing tonight anyway? Like I said, chilled out. Nothing to worry about, no speedruns, nothing like that. It's just chill.
In this scene, Vince and Ray escape to the docks with the safe in the back of the car. I need to do a 180 turn here, then stop close to the jetty edge to make it look good.
Makes sense. Yeah, hopefully the mic's picking me up okay as well. You guys can hear me, right? I hope so.
Toothless and Whopping, scene 6, take 1. Hit the boxes. Through the gap. Hit the boxes. Door off the van. Brake at the boxes and swing round. Stop at the end and reverse. Brake. Accelerate for the jump. Brake at the end. Cut.
8%. Ooh. Can I restart that one? Yeah, I can. Let's do that again. I actually got pretty close to 100% in that first try. I mean, hey, I can mess up the thing. That's good.
Take 2. Hit the boxes. Through the gap. Hit the boxes. Door off the van. Brake at the boxes and swing round. Stop at the end and reverse. Accelerate for the jump.
Oops. Fell off. Whoops. And cut. Oh, God.
Take three.
The best thing is, it keeps track of how many attempts you took by saying take three. After a bit, it just gives up.
Through the gap. Hit the boxes. Door off the van. Break at the boxes and swing round. Stop at the end and reverse. Break. Accelerate for the jump. Break at the end. Cut.
Oof, that was close. Ah, we got the car. Nice. I don't have a drink on me at all. Oops. Oh well, it's fine. Whew.
Now Vince and Ray ditch the safe and get chased by the police. For the finish, I drive up and over a dumpster, making sure I get enough speed into the jump to make a wreck of the car.
Right, got you. Sounds good enough to me. This should be interesting. Let's see what we got.
Toothless and Whopping, scene 8, take 1. Up the jetty, hit the life ring. Through the warehouse, hit the trash cans. Into the warehouse. Up the steps. And right turn. Through the roadworks. Into the tunnel.
Uh-oh. Well.
Overtake. Overtake. Through the gap. Over the dumpster. And cut.
Nice. 93%. I won't bother about that. Did alright. Yeah. Got the next one. Feels worth playing this game again, because it's been a while. Also, thanks Laura for the idea as well.
I drive a police car chasing one of the densest gangsters around warehouses. I need to stick close the whole time to make it look right. At the end of the stunt, I have to ram the lead car into the river.
Sounds straightforward enough. I mean, how bad can this go? I'm in a police car as well. Ooh. Do I have any? I wonder if I have a horn. I'll find out.
Toothless, scene 24, take 1. Give chase. Between the cars. Stick with him. Cut down to the lead vehicle.
He went a bit too slow. Oh boy. This is going to be a long night, isn't it? I mean, I don't mind. I'm fine with this. Still. There we go. Take 2. Action.
Give chase. Between the cars. Stick with him.
Okay, this time I'm not going to bother with the siren. Also, the wipe there. My god. Don't hit the lead car.
Hit the barrels. Through the warehouse. Into the boxes. Check with him.
I mean, what else can I do, right?
Left of the first container.
Right of the second.
Right of the second. Left again. Under the crane. Into the lead car.
Yes.
Cut.
But you have to knock him off. Also, you know you want to watch that one back, right? Oh yeah. I think it's gonna look so bad, it'll look like the world's slowest car chase. But, you know. I'm intrigued to see what it's gonna look like. There we go. I like how it slows down on the camera too, the replay. Look how slow I had to go because of him. Like, come on. That ain't fun. The fact you have to actually slow down because you'll hit him is a joke. Ridiculous. Lose the tail, man. I know, yeah. He can't do it. I'm keeping up with him. By the way, this is edited to look like it's in a movie. A pretty good job of that. Hey, down he goes. Yeah, next stunt. It looked like the worst thing.
Basic ways to roll a car. There's a pipe ramp, literally driving the subframe up a pipe. There's also what we call a cannon roll, which we're gonna do next. We make it look as if it's a collision that turns the car, when in fact I got a button by the handbrake that shoots a pole out from under the chassis of the car when I slide the car sideways at exactly the right moment. And that'll flick me over. I just have to be sure to press it at the right time.
Huh. Okay. So basically you press it at the wrong time, everything goes to pop. I think it's L1, that's the button. Can't quite remember. I think it's L1 or R1.
This is one of the final scenes in the film, and here I chase the dentist's white van. To complete the stunt, I cannon roll the car as the van rams me. If I mess up the timing, I'll wreck the car, but we won't be able to use the footage.
Okay. I think I can do that. This one should be an interesting scene to shoot. Also, hopefully the sound's alright. Hopefully I've not turned the game too loud. There we go.
Toothless, scene 39. Take one. Chase the van. Keep up with the van.
I'm trying.
Jump through the boxes.
God,
that's too slow.
I flip the car. I forget how easy the car's flipping this. Take two. The funny thing is, he gets more aggravated with the more takes that it takes you to do it. There you go.
Take two.
Take three, and eventually it goes, it's like scene 24, and action. It doesn't even bother saying take, whatever. The less takes you do it in the better, I think. Also, I should just explain, this game is hard as nails too.
Jump through the boxes. Get close to the truck.
Hello, truck.
Swerve around the truck. Onto the platform. Through the boxes. Dodge the forklift and down. Into the warehouse. Through the gap. Under the ladder.
Ah.
Cannon roll.
Whoa.
And cut.
I mean, sure. Nice. Next stunt.
So this behind me is the stunt arena where I do a bit of work between movie contracts. It's a place where I can sharpen up on some skills and learn a few new ones. Plus, it keeps me busy and the blood pumping. I'm gonna have to shoot. I got a show tonight.
Oh, I remember this one. Yeah. So between, like I said, between films, he has these thrill shows, and they start the range from, general stuff from like, what is it? From normal stuff to like firing a car out of a cannon like this to synchronized driving to monster trucks and loop-de-loops. It's crazy. Also, he'll smash through a burning building. Well, he actually smashes through several. You'll see what I mean. This is actually quite tricky from correctly. How did I fail that? Interesting. Okay. Try it again. Take two. Luckily this one doesn't say take two and action. Why am I late to this? Alright, you've not missed much, Slowrider. I missed it completely. How did I miss? So first I was too slow and messed it up. Then the second time I completely missed it. He's away. Why they don't play Let the Beast Sign Get You? Let the Beast Sign Get You after this, I don't know. And poof. What? That's a fail. How is this a fail? How am I failing this? Come on. I get the first bit. Oh, can I just drive around that? Actually, I'm not even going to bother with that one. I am not even going to bother thinking about that. Let's just go. Okay. I don't know how many attempts this has been. Three? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Boom. What? How am I... I hit that one. Or does it want me to, like, hit bang on? I don't know. I forget this game can be off sometimes. You're supposed to do this jump, pass through all of the burning building things, the burning fences, then jump into... Whoosh! Apparently I'm just losing this. This game doesn't like me at all, does it? It's supposed to be so easy! Through the second. I completely missed that one. I believe you can... You have to hit it like bang on, like boom. Smash straight into it. I can never remember how to do this. How is that a fail? Like, I'm smashing into it. This game hates me. What am I doing wrong? Okay, so avoiding that is something you can't do. Me being smart with that one wasn't a good idea. Okay, here we go. And go. Trust it to be as soon as Slow Rider joins, everything goes wrong. Come on! Alright, hit the bloody car! There we go. There. Gee whiz. Done it. Nice. So we've done Toothless and Whopping. Now we're on to Wolfen and a Hollering in Louisiana, USA. Nice.
We're gonna use nitro for this stunt. That's nitrous oxide. We inject it directly into the cylinders to increase horsepower. With the setup we're working on, we're looking to boost the HP from 375 to 525 to clear the jump.
What the hell? 150 horsepower. Nice.
This movie's about bootleggers, moonshine, the county sheriff, and the innocent Basco boys. This is the part where Haynes's moonshine is in the drains and starts exploding all over town. There's a bunch of pyrotechnics here, so timing is critical, especially when the chimneys start coming down. I need to hit the
also,
nitro
driver three,
exactly
police
at
siren.
The right moment to make the last jump.
You're welcome. The police sirens that were in this were the same ones that they reused for Driver 3 as well. They were used here and then got put into the Driver 3 game. I'm not surprised because Atari developed Driver 3 as well as this. So, yeah, whooping and a hollering.
A whooping, scene 32, take one. Right through the fence. Make the jump. Aim for the chimney.
Please make this jump. Hey, dude.
Jump between the trains. Hard right through the burning shed. Jump through the train. Wrong way.
Wow. I got hit by the train. I didn't go too quick. Okay, note to self. Go a bit quicker through that bit. Got it. The train took me with it. That was a nice one. Thanks, train. I guess that train just liked me a little bit too much. Okay, here we go. Cut. Where are you going?
Right through the fence. Make the jump. Aim for the chimney.
Please make the chimney.
Jump between the trains. Turn right for the burning shed. Jump through the train. Right turn, head for the crossing. Get close to the explosion. Hard left, through traffic. Hard right, through the fence. Jump the pool. Stay left on the second. Through the fence and hard right. Between the cars. Left, head to the garage. Close to the explosion. Through the gap. Under the first chimney. Under the second. Through the billboard, jump the river. Head left, back onto the road.
Get ready for the nitro.
Accelerate to make the jump. Get ready for the nitro. Now.
That made it. No way. I was like, uh-oh. Did you see my damage at the top? Holy crap. Oh, we gotta watch that back. Mate, that was amazing. It got right to the end. Damaged it, flipped for ages, and still landed. Oh, mate. Yes. That was amazing. I do like this, though. The camera view's great. Sorry about your chimney! Chicken run across the road! It wouldn't be a redneck film without chickens, would it? There we go. Whoosh! I hit the cop car there, I wasn't supposed to, but whatever. It looks pretty good when they put it in this camera view. I only moved over there so I get close to things. I managed to correct my mistakes and still beat this 100%. Don't know how. Jump the swimming pool, stay left of the second. Go through the fence. I love how I'm like, uh-oh. Through the cars. Near the explosion. Narrow passage. Underneath the first chimney. Underneath the second. Through the billboard and out. Now that's the money shot right there. Back onto the road. There we go. Here's the bit. Here's the money shot. That is how you finish a scene. I just remember the 1 LP of this and how much you struggle with, well, everything. It's hard as hell.
This is for the corkscrew jump we're doing next. It's pretty complex, and the computers use NASA technology to work out the speed and trajectory.
Almost certainly because he was handbraking every car, so he probably was. I only handbrake when I get told to.
The weight's been distributed centrally through the car, so I'm completely balanced. The trick here is to get your speed right, and the ramp does the work. Then all you have to do is try to land on the nose, or it's a real bone shaker.
That's just... the corkscrew at the end. Oh, Jesus. It's going to be a fun one, isn't it? Corkscrew time, folks. Place your money. How many attempts is this one I'm going to take before I don't get it, before I get it right?
This chase is at speed. The Basco boys trying to settle a score with Hanus, the bootlegger.
Holy crap, Stuntman was a part of my childhood.
The chase ends.
I bet it's been a while since you've seen this, hasn't it, Jazzo? I was like, hey, dude. How you doing? See, you got one from ESA Winter, alright. As well. I know it's been a while, but, you know, still. It's very difficult for my child brain. It is a hard game. I mean, we're only just on a whooping and a hollering, so it took a couple attempts to do one or two of these. You're gonna get to see me struggle for this one as well.
A whooping, scene 9, take 1.
How do I go? Oh, follow the car, okay.
Chase the car. Get close and overtake.
There we go. The fact that it has a radius that you have to.
Through the roadworks and over the jump.
Oh, okay. Oh, yay.
Keep up with the car.
Oh, hello.
Right down the dirt track.
Come on, go up.
Get close to the pickup.
I'm on it. Jesus. I think I failed that already. Too slow, yeah.
Let's do it again.
God, people make it look way easier. Oh, man. I played through the, I did a speedrun of the GBA version of this, the Game Boy Advance version. And it is way easier. Because it has a two... The thing is, the Game Boy Advance version has a tutorial section. So basically, when you start the game, you get to go through all the films and do several stunts, except the pass rate is lowered because it's like a beginner section. Once you've done that, it goes into actual films, and the films become way, way more difficult.
Hard right down the dirt track.
There we are.
Get close to the pickup.
So there you go, you learn something new every day. Do I have to do something with the trees there? I don't know. We're doing great, honestly. I was working remotely even before lockdown and all that, so I was fully prepared. Nice.
Around the roadblock and through the fence.
I missed that.
Through the trees. Smash through the fence. Get close to the pickup and overtake. Get close to the van and overtake.
Come on. Don't lose him, don't lose him, don't lose him, don't lose him. Getting this by skin of your teeth.
Through the barn.
Yeah, I've still got to do work, unfortunately, but there's not a lot I can do about that.
Smash through the fence. Jump over the fence.
Nice.
180 handbrake.
Yes! Yes! Yeah! First try, over the corkscrew. Now that is something I'll never do again. Oh, that was good. Yeah, I've still got to work from home. Not work from home, sorry. I've still got to go to work in the morning to me. Use NASA technology to count your trajectory. Exactly.
It's now the turn of Heinous to be chased by the sheriff. I'm driving as Heinous here.
They had a few
the
things.
The most complex parts of this stunt are good. Driving along the carriage roofs, dropping into the flatbed,
no, but
and
in
the
terms
end,
of work,
getting off the bridge in time to avoid the train, but doing
in terms of,
to make it look
yeah.
Good.
In terms of work, I still have to drive to and from work because what we do is we make medical gas alarms and things like that. And it's quite important because they're used in medical facilities and hospitals and all that stuff. And obviously, given the current pandemic, there's quite a bit of demand for medical supplies, as you might imagine. So,
a weapon, that's scene 12, take one.
Ooh, oh god, this thing's fast. Bloody hell. Whoa, mama.
Through the roadworks, aim for the train. Get to the flatbed. Onto the platform, off the end. Between the cars. Through the side.
Through.
At the table. Between the cars. Through the car wash. Get ahead of the train.
Already on it. Holy crap! That was close.
Drive between the trains.
Holy hell.
Tracks. Over the bridge, dodge the train. And
again, another first try. That's pretty good. I will take that. Oh, I got an arena title too. Nice. Also, I'm intrigued. What did that look like? Yeah, so like I said, at the moment, because of all the medical supplies and stuff like that, Jazzo, it means that we're having to make quite a bit, so I'm quite busy at the moment at work. I've still got to go in and do my job, because it's not a job I can do from home, unfortunately, but what can you do? Also, I'm real looking forward to seeing both my burnout run and your racing pitch run on the ESHL on YouTube, to see what sort of response they both get. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, I'd expect it to be quite random. I love how it's just completely nope. Oh god. It's a train, his train. Where am I? Holy crap. Right, so after I turn left, oh well. That's fine. Also, best thing is, you can actually get ahead of that. If you're fast enough, you can get ahead of this. I have to, but it's fine. You can actually, I was kind of like grinding my way along the side of the train then as well. Job well done. Let's do the next one. Oh, that's it. Oh, damn. We're done with a whooping and a hollering. Nice. So that means we've now got... car dominoes. Oh, gee whiz. This one ain't going to be fun. Ready to see some car destruction? You know you wanna. There we are. So I've got to go and hit all these, then crash through the billboard. I think I can do that. Is there anything on here? Nope. It seems to be fine. Alright, here we go. Oh god, we're going to have to slip the strip time on there. Did I do it? I did! Yay! I passed! Nice. Ooh. This one looks serious. Oh no. I know exactly. Yeah. I think I know which one this is. Yeah, I pressed it, but I think you have to hit it as you drive over. Tuk tuks, yeah. Oh boy.
One of the most dangerous stunts to do is a crowd scatter. You have to time them just right, and you got no depth perception with something head on. If people go too soon, it looks wrong, and they can't leave it late. It's extremely dangerous for the stunt people as pedestrians, so it's a big responsibility. We're going to do a complex crowd scatter in an interior next.
Which, I'll be honest, Blood Oath is my favorite and my least favorite of the films, because... My favourite because it has two of my favourite cars. The least favourite because it has the tuk-tuks. So the two first two acts we're doing are really fun, and the last two acts are really awful. It involves driving a tuk-tuk, and they drive like crap. And they are hard as nails to hit first try. I'm not joking.
Blood Oath is a hard-edged thriller. Here we've got rival gangs fighting for control of the Bangkok streets. The actor I double for is racing against time. Speeding down the freeway, smashing through a rigged office building, and jumping out through the window at the end.
This one is good. Believe me when I say this one's good. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's that one. Landing the jump, slow rider, that's the one. There we go.
Blood Oath, scene 8, take 1, action. Get close and overtake.
There's another car in there somewhere you have to overtake.
Overtake. Overtake. Through the barrier.
Car. That ain't what I wanted to happen. Uh-oh. I actually meant to dodge that. I thought if I stayed on the right, he wouldn't appear, but no, he did. It's a good job I'm playing these through again, because it's getting my mind ready. There we go.
Take 2. Action. Get close and overtake. Overtake.
I do like this. Oh, this has one of the worst overtake things in the game. Believe me when I say it is the worst.
Back through the barrier. Overtake. Left bend. Scrape along bus. Squeeze past truck.
There we go.
Overtake.
Where's the next one?
Squeeze past truck. Through the barrier. Get close. Back through the barrier. Overtake.
No, no, it's alright.
Into the back of the trailer and out.
Give me a minute, Chazzo. I'll explain a little bit. I can explain a little bit. Oh god.
Through barrier and into building.
Oh god.
Onto the transporter. Cut.
100%, there we go. Nice. Drive one pick in the office. I didn't even see that. Was there a drive one pick? I'll have to have a look. I'll do a replay, why not? Sorry, mate, the connection sucks balls. Now I heard the part about your job and something about racing pitch. What did you ask? So, what I was saying was in terms of... That was it. I was saying... I said I can't wait to see the reaction that we get. I can't wait till my Burnout 3 run goes up on the ESA channel and the racing pitch run that you did also go up on the ESA channel, because I think it's going to get quite a funny or odd reception. Because I think it'll be like it'll be a mixed reaction, but hopefully it's more the funny one than, if that makes sense, the more funny reaction from the crowd than anything else. Because I had a blast, it was great fun. And it took me by surprise, I didn't know what to expect. I don't think Tricro knew either. So you took us both by surprise, which was nice. Also, this makes my driving look way better. It actually does. Like, you know it's bad when a game makes your driving look better than it actually is. Through the back of the truck. There we go. Yeah, I get what you mean. Really great for you. I've got sorry. Hey, I'm glad you asked me, man. I mean, I think what's he called? What was the other guy called? Oops. Driver 2 poster. I just saw it. And driver. Yeah, driver and driver 2 poster in the game. Nice. Now we're ready. Here we go. Out the window. Onto the casual sporter. That kind of almost worked. There you go. Yeah! Cut! Nice. No, I'm glad you asked me, because I think Simple Unit, I think he's called, also asked me for Destruction Derby 2 to be a co-commentator if it got in the open block, and it didn't, but I said, yeah, I'll be up for it. To be honest, Simple Unit, yourself, and a couple other guys in the Polish community all took me by surprise, and I'm very grateful as well, because... I didn't think that a lot of people knew me or who I was, and surprisingly, I'm guessing poker told people, but I'm like, you know, like I never thought I'd speak to you during the event or to Simple Unit. I didn't even know who you guys were until we started talking. So
high performance cars through the
whoever's spilled the thing out, you know, sideways. Most of the sequence. Thank you very much. But like I said, I'm very glad that you asked me. I mean, I don't know everything there is to know about cars, but I'm definitely a racing guy and a car guy at heart. So, but yeah, no worries. I'm glad that I did commentary with you, because like I said, you took me by surprise. So it's quite nice. But you know, oh, Kadzik and Poker. Oh, very nice. There has actually been talks. Not with me initially, but I was actually looking at going to favorite car. I was looking at going to GSPS at some point next year. Although things might have changed a bit by then. I don't know. We'll see what I can do. Hey, it does. Oh god.
Up the transport.
Uh oh.
To the truck.
Holy crap! Oh, oh. That actually worked. Can I do this first try? Please say yes.
Swerve through the traffic. Oh. The sidewalk.
Oops. There's two things I messed up. Uh oh. Car, no. Come on.
Left into the alley.
Poor skyline. I feel sorry for this car now.
Make the jump.
I missed the jump at the end. Oh well. Also, Tuskinity redeemed it. You're going too fast. Okay. Tuskinity, you're going too fast. Slow down. Jesus Christ, you're gonna hit a tree. Slow down, Colin. I can't quite do it, but you're going too fast.
Action. Left into the alley. Accelerate.
And stop.
Now speed reverse.
Quick. Go. Oof.
Through the traffic.
Ah!
Left into the alley. Into the trash cans.
Into the trash cans. Oh boy.
Up the transporter.
How the hell? I'm only just landing that.
Into the trash
cans. Oh, whatever. That's good.
Swerve through the traffic, onto the sidewalk.
Wait. Can I go off? Yeah, I can.
Cut. Stick to the roof.
Nice. You can actually wreck the car, by the way, by just driving off. I wanted to do that because to show you two things. Firstly, that you can wreck a car by driving it in C. Second of all, because that scene was going bad, so I thought I'd wreck the car. That's a wee too fast, don't you think?
Take three.
I mean, yeah. And bang. Okay. I have to admit, the jumps on this.
Through the traffic.
Oh, hello.
Left into the alley. Into the trash can.
This one is way harder than it looks.
Up the transporter. To the truck.
To the truck. Oh, over the car, too. That one was actually a lot better.
Through the traffic, onto the sidewalk.
Excuse me. Coming through.
Left into the alley.
Okay, so I can still mess this up by means of not getting the jump. Yes! 100%! Nice! And I got the car, and I got a bus. Yes. Oh no.
We ripped out the 250cc engines on the tuk-tuks and given them 500s. Should be able to get 0 to 60 in about 6 in these. But they flip pretty easy.
Good question.
Is, so this makes them worse, and the roll cages get a good workout.
Yeah, you might be able to do that. I don't know. I mean, if you do everything else and then fail the last jump. No, they usually have to get you. I think you can mess things up, but as long as you get the last jump in most things, you'd be fine. I mean, that's what it's like normally. Uh-oh.
This chase is quite unusual because we're using three-wheeled cabs called tuk-tuks.
Uh-oh.
But that still means I need to stay close to the lead to make the chase look as realistic as possible.
Please don't tell me I have to jump that ramp with the tuk-tuk. Oh boy, Slow Ride's gonna enjoy me with this one. Unless I pass it first try, which is a fucking miracle.
Blood Oath, scene 35, take one, chase the tuk-tuk.
These things shift, man.
Boxes. Close to the car.
Stop, where are you going?
Left into alley, getting close.
Hit the boxes. I've already screwed that up. I need to like reset. The advert for TIW on the back. TIW? It's gonna hit me now when it shows up. Toothless and Whopping. Ah.
Chase the
we are in Thailand, so you know they often have adverts for films that are either not out or are out. Just different countries. I somehow managed to make that.
Left into alley, getting close.
Hit
boxes.
Yep, yeah.
Hit boxes.
More boxes.
Park left into market. Jump.
Jump.
Through the sharp corner. Through the traffic.
Oh, I didn't even know that was a thing.
Through the corridor. God, let's do it again.
Nice. And it blocked that up completely. Okay, right. I have to really get used to the turning. Like, my God, the turning's strange on this. By the way, I'm using the D-pad for this. There's my controller. It's plugged in. I'm using the D-pad for driving.
Take three.
Not the analog. Try the analog, actually.
Chase the tuk-tuk. Hit boxes.
It's way worse.
Close to the car.
I mean, I am.
Left into alley, getting close. Hit the boxes. Hit boxes.
If I hit him, it's game over, by the way. Woo!
Through the sharp corner. Swerve through the traffic.
Okay, through that one. Right beside that one.
Through the corridor. Left onto the road.
I got stuck! Ow. My god. Just, I got like a little tiny bit further. We're not even at the hardest bit yet. For those that don't know, at the end of this one, I think it's the end of this, or during near the end of it, well, near the last part of this one,
rolling.
There's jumps. And I mean like rooftop jumps.
Chase the tuk-tuk. Hit boxes.
Also, your pass rate goes up through this one. How the hell? I hit that car and yet still managed to keep up.
Left into alley, getting close. Hit the boxes.
That might be a good herring, actually. Whoa.
Hard left into
I really don't want to hit him.
Through the sharp corner.
Oh, okay. I may have just took half that market stall down, but I don't care. We're in a tuk-tuk. Come on.
Swerve through the traffic.
Don't stop me now. I'm driving a tuk-tuk.
Through the corridor. Left onto the road.
Right.
Swerve through the traffic. Through the gap.
Ah, sorry. I missed that one.
Break. Cut.
Not bad. Okay, there isn't a jump in that one. It's just that really tight, tight thing at the end. Okay. Phew.
A box rig is just a landing pad made up of empty cardboard boxes that'll bring you to a safe stop. Because it's never the falling that hurts, it's the stopping.
This one's a lot worse.
The one we're using now isn't as high as we'd usually use because it's built into a boat. We're still about 7 or 8 feet off the height we'd normally have for a jump like this.
There is a jump, I think, right at the very end, which is onto a boat. And it's not easy. So I've been told.
My tuk-tuk is getting shot at by the chopper here. Most of the chase takes place on the rooftop, but at the end, I need to jump from the jetty onto a passing barge where the box rig is set up.
Been a while since I played it? Yeah, it's been a while since I played it too. That's why I'm playing it back through again. Yo! How you doing, Simon? I think there's one for that where I used to fall a lot. Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Auto, scene 52, take one.
Oh boy.
Action. Through traffic. Close to the explosion.
Where the hell am I going? There we go.
Up the ramp. Into the building. Crowd scatter. Onto the rooftop. Hard right, close to the explosion. Explosion. Make the jump.
I made that one.
Make the jump.
Oh boy. I don't know about that one though. Hey, okay, we made it. Just about. I don't care if I'm...
Over the bridge.
Yeah.
Over the chopper. Across the exploding bridge.
Uh-oh.
Wrong way.
I thought we were going to fall off. Okay, we did all right to get that far without flipping the thing over. Good God. I'm glad I got that far without it failing. Bloody hell. Okay, let's see if we do any better in this
Take
one.
Two.
So you get better with the explosions.
Action. Traffic. Close to the explosion.
Yeah.
Up the ramp. Into the building. Crowd scatter.
Run people over. Bye.
Onto the rooftop.
You're in the way. Uh-oh.
Hard right. Close to the explosion.
I'm pretty sure it's possible
explosion.
I'm pretty sure it's possible for him to blow you
Make
up.
The jump.
I could be wrong though. Crap, I missed the jump.
Make the jump! Explosion!
Also, can I just jump off there?
Cut! Stick to the root!
I can. The reason why I did that was because I wanted to restart. I should have just restarted as soon as I failed the jump, but never mind. This one actually doesn't give you much leeway, so you can, like, fail one jump and not fail the others. Proper arse. Plus the jumps are worth a lot in this too. I get it. No, I 100% get it.
Close to the explosion.
Oh, that was close.
Up the ramp. Into the building. Crowd scatter. Onto the rooftop.
Jesus, come on. I'm gonna miss this one for damn sure.
Hard right, close to the explosion. Explosion. Make the jump. Make the jump. Explosion. Over the bridge. Over the chopper.
Come on.
across the exploding bridge.
Down.
Onto the canopy.
Oh, crap. No, no.
The end and straight ahead.
I made that? No.
Up the box ramp.
Oh, we did.
Trailer. Through the gap. Explosion. Onto the cut. That's way too slow.
God. Well, I'm glad I got right near the end. I made the jump. How did I make that? As in, I made the one with the lorry. The lorry usually flips you over, for those that don't know. You hit it. Woo.
Rolling.
God. Yeah, I always did with the same with me.
Through traffic. Close to the explosion. Up the ramp.
Okay.
Into the building. Crowd scatter.
Yeah. Run for your life, people. It's just a tuck-tuck.
Onto the rooftop. Hard right. Close to the explosion. Explosion. Make the jump.
Hey.
Make the jump. Explosion.
Ah. Main explosion. Whatever.
Over the bridge. Over the chopper.
No.
Across the exploding bridge. Onto the canopy. Off the end and straight ahead.
Come.
Up the box ramp, through the trailer, through the gap. Explosion. Onto the jetty. Make the charge. And cut.
Amazing. Nice. We gotta watch that back. Like we've gotta watch that back. Like come on. We gotta see how bad that looks. That's gotta look so bad. Surely that's gotta look bad. There we go. Ready? Go. Boom. Whee! This is the thing. When you view the replay, you view of how the actual scene's gonna look. So now we're getting to see how bad my driving looks. This is how it actually looks if it was in a movie. Yeah! Over the helicopter, go on! Hooray! Yeah! Truth be told, that actually wasn't as bad as I thought. I remember that being really difficult, that wasn't actually too difficult. Surprisingly, the jumps were nice to me. I guess I finally got hold of this game and got used to it a little bit after all these years. Apart from this bit. Bang. Oh yeah, I'm not doing 100% of it. If I pass it, I pass. Here we go! That's the money shot. Boom. And for the finale. The fact that I actually landed on all three wheels was pretty impressive. Yeah. Oh boy. Lucky O'Sullivan's Irish Hell Drivers. I remember this. This is the one where you have to drive in sequence with all the others. It is a pain in the ass. So bad. Precision formations, Ryan, as he says. It's hard as hell. The snake is where you follow the rest. The diamond is where the split, and then the other ones go whoosh, and then whoosh. I love that. All the time, dangerously close together. Well, really, they're not that close. They're not that close. Also, I should clarify, this is being played on actual PlayStation. PlayStation 2. I should bring this with me when I go to ESA next, if there's another one. This actually is where it gets difficult. This one, I believe, I've been told, is the most boring one. Damn. How did I damage it? Oh, I got so close. Okay, maybe I have to just wait until he goes and then set off. I don't know. The next ESA, there's ESA Together, which I think is in 3 weeks' time. I think it's 3 weeks. I don't know, maybe somebody can correct me. 3 weeks' time from now. Over the jumps, here we go. Ooh, I think is ESA Together, which is in like 3 weeks' time, I think. All the others. And then there's also another one as well. Snow and Potato equals Snow Tato is here to watch those men from Island 2, whatever is happening in this oval trap. Hey! Come on, where is it? Nice. Also, the Snow Tato, thank you very much for the follow. Oh god. Yes! So, this is where it gets interesting. So what's going to happen now is these guys are all going to do a jump. Ow! What? I damaged the chase vehicle. How did I damage it? I didn't even touch him. Did I nudge him? I must have nudged him. Whatever. Take three. Formation drone is not what I wanted to do. If I ram him, does that count? Why doesn't even count as damage? Oh, there you go. Okay, so if I hit him or if I grind the back of his car, it damages him. Gotcha. I did not hit him. I did not. Oh, hi, Samuel. Cool. I like you thinking, Snow Tato. I like it. I did not hit him. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark. Yeah, I like it. I like the reference. I thought of it that way. I did not hit him. I did not. Oh, hi, Sam. Oh, cool. There we go. Ooh. If it says now that I have hit him, I swear to God. There we go. Also, yeah, you get to see me suffer. Normally, I should just clarify something. So normally I do speedruns of racing games. Tonight is just a casual playthrough of this because it could potentially be a future run that I decide to do. Okay. Slow down, let him go past. Keep up with him. Hopefully I should do. Got you. Best thing about this one, you just drive like this. Wow, okay. Did I do it? I did! Yes! I might have failed it slightly, but I don't care. We did it. Next stunt. Oh, thank God. Oh. No. I think I know exactly what film this is. Oh. Not conspiracy. So, this legit has one of the worst things in the game.
No, they're beasts. 1,000 cc
horsepower,
but they handle like cows if you're too heavy on the throttle. We started the movie with 28. We're down to 19 just from rehearsals.
He said no, like he heard you. It's like no. Yeah, exactly. No, so the second level of this is very horrible. The reason why, put it blatantly, is because you're on a ski thing. And it's constantly flying. You constantly have to drive. You're like, oof, going down the Alps. It's crazy.
I get to double the lead. This stunt.
Snowmobiles suck, but no, the beasts. At the end, I know, it was pretty good coincidence, wasn't it? I dive
from my seat before the snowmobile crashes. This sequence involves big roof jumps. In the hardest one, I need to land on the balcony of the building opposite and crash through the window.
Oh. Also, conspiracy, suspect everyone. I think it's the first one, and I think the first stunt and the last stunt are actually not that bad.
Conspiracy, scene 28, take one. Cut, stick to the route.
Oops. Oh, live twice for tomorrow. Where the hell am I going for this?
Cut, wrong way.
I've done it again. Where am I supposed to go? Do I go straight and round? I'm guessing so. I just follow the arrows, right? Okay. Two attempts, both failing. Okay, third attempt, here we go. How am I supposed to go?
Into the skis.
Oh, hello.
Jump the gap. Chase the marked snowmobile. Through the window, onto the roof, and swing left.
on it. Okay, so the first part seemed alright with that one, it was just that jump I messed up on. I'm surprised I got the one that goes through the balcony, by the way. That was insane. There we go. Okay, right. Yeah, after a bit he just gives up saying action. I don't blame the guy, to be honest, do you?
Into the skis.
Over the jump.
Jump the gap.
I like how that's actually a thing, jump the gap. You can actually hit that guy too. I should probably clarify this. Also, how is this able to go on here? How? Somebody explain the logic in that one. Whee! In one side, out the other.
Through the window.
Yeah.
The roof and swing left.
That's it, fellas. Keep firing at me. Okay. Turn right. Yep, yeah. Oh, God. No, no, no. Seconds. We got enough time.
Jump and swing right. Cut. Too slow.
Damn it. Okay, so it's over the jump. Right, so when it curves round, go left over the jump, go right straight away, or go up and right as you jump, I guess.
Rolling.
The worst thing is, this isn't even the worst one. The worst one's coming next. Yep. Jump.
Jump the gap. Chase the marked snowmobile.
Come on. Oh. You went the wrong way then. I think you can accidentally hit people too. Nah, resetting that one. Messed that one up badly. Good grief. Also, live twice with tomorrow, Slow Rider. That one is very difficult, yes. I'll give you that. There's some really good stunts in there as well. Just so difficult. I think it's like 2 minutes constant driving. It's pretty bad.
Into the skis.
Okay. Let's not do that one. Let's restart again. It lived twice. I was stuck in the police chase. Oh, the police chase was the Fiat 500 looking thing, wasn't it? Yeah, I remember.
Rolling.
Yeah, that is hard. That is difficult. My worst one, truth be told, wasn't that one. My worst one was the, I think it was one more near the start, actually. More near the start of the actual, start of the film. Come on.
Up onto the terrace.
Up onto the terrace. Through tables and stuff. Down.
Up the roof and jump.
Do I have enough speed? Yes, I do. And do I have enough?
Through the window, onto the roof, and swing left. Chase.
I'm on it.
Jump and swing right.
Get ready to jump off. Jump. Cut. Yes. Sick. We're done. done it, and 100% it too. Yes. Worst thing is, that's the one of the easiest ones. One of the easiest ones in the film. This one's a hard one. Watch this again at first try for some odd reason. Again, getting these in one try is, like, an accomplishment.
This sequence is the lead character's snowmobile being chased by armed microlights and snowmobiles.
Those are all the worst.
There's a number of explosions here. I need to get close to them. This chase also includes a big gorge jump and avoiding falling trees.
Microlight had shark teeth. Yeah. Microlight, I mean, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it does. It's funny, the little details you notice. I do not want to do... I just want to get this one done, because... the end of it? Yeah, it's going to be really hard.
Conspiracy, scene 32, take one. Action. Explosion.
I messed it up already. Oh, dear. Well, that didn't take long, did it? I was like, it'll take a while before it happens. Nope.
Take two.
Take two. I'm gonna be like, take eight of them.
So.
Move it!
Explosion! Explosion!
Right. So, I believe if you get stuck... if you get stuck... at any point during this, it screwed the whole thing up because you're constantly going at speed.
Take three.
So I need to make sure I do this right.
Action.
I have to get it all in one go. This is the worst one. Oh, come on.
Explosion. Explosion.
Does the motherfucker say player on it? I think so.
Explosion. Jump over the ravine.
Think so, I'm not sure.
Explosion!
Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Explosion!
Ha! I'm gonna miss a load of these.
Jump over the falling tree!
Whoa!
Over the trees! Explosion!
Ah! Don't kill me!
Smash through the snowman!
I'd rather not.
Hit the micro light! Explosion.
I'm putting my foot down. Also, look, Ma, no hands.
Cut. You're hitting the camera.
That was brilliant. I hit the camera crew dead. Yeah. Oh god.
Action.
Oh Jesus. Oh. Okay, right. Come on. Come on, go.
Explosion.
Also, when I went what the hell before, it's because
through the trees.
For whatever reason
explosion.
The explosion decided to make me fight into the air. That's why I went further than I normally do.
Explosion.
I'm like, whoa. Okay, explosion. Yeah. It's fine. I'm gonna make this.
Jump over the falling tree.
Yeah, I got it.
Yikes! Trees.
Jesus.
Explosion.
Okay, where's the friggin'.
Smash through the snowman. Jump off the roof. Hit the microlight.
Yes.
Stay ahead of the snowmobile.
Well, I can't exactly do that
explosion.
Because now. Oh, give me a break. Stay ahead of the snow. How are you supposed to stay ahead of him? Uh oh. Stop! Stop! It's alright. I'll just reverse.
Cut and again.
Call the paramedics. Okay, so. As I mentioned, this one is tough. Also, getting the microlight, yeah, good luck with that. 100% in this one is difficult. I've said that word like 100 times now. This whole game is difficult, okay? Oh boy.
Explosion.
Give me a break. I'm not gonna do this.
Explosion.
No, I'm gonna pause. I'll redo that one. It's pretty much blind. Yeah, you can't see anything. The fact that I hit the snowman made me quite happy. I was like, yeah, I got it.
Rolling.
Okay, right. Here we go again.
Action.
They have movie trailers for this. I should point this out. Every film has a movie trailer, and
explosion.
It's supposedly you that's driving, but really it isn't you driving. You know this because, well, you're like, I don't remember driving that much when I did my thing. Oh, Christ. Oh, hello. Right. Interesting. Another retake. This is going to take a while, I think. This will take a while. I've said this could be a future speedrun. Potentially. I really have to nail these stunts, though, if I'm going to do a run of this. Because there's no way you can just run this game. No way.
Explosion.
You need, like, 100-odd fails breeze. Before you can actually do anything.
Explosion.
Okay, right. Oh! Oh!
Where are you going?
I think I just killed someone. Holy crap, I didn't realise there was people in the cabin. Okay, well, I guess we know where not to go. I'm having fun doing this, though, I have to admit. Even though it's hard, it's a fun time. Really have to nail everything. Oh, crap. No, that ain't good. No! I'm supposed to be in front of you! Dipstick. Come on. No, missed it. Okay.
Two.
One.
Explosion.
Zero.
Jump over the ravine.
Okay, come on.
Explosion.
Okay,
Explosion. Jump over the falling tree.
Whee! Uh-oh. Oh!
Through the trees.
Help!
Explosion.
No! Okay, sod it. Going for it.
Jump on the roof. Hit the micro light. Stay ahead of the
freaking
snowman.
Hell.
Explosion.
Yeah, okay. That was dead the moment I hit, I got red on a couple of them jumps. Yeah, that was, like, game over. Jesus. Oh, this one's hard. Hang on, wait. What film are we at? Film 4, right? Yeah, fourth film. The worst thing is we've got Scarab of Lost Souls and Live Twice for Tomorrow to go, and them films are exceedingly difficult. Meaning, get ready to watch me suffer more than what you normally do. Okay. Okay. Come on. 4. Okay.
Explosion.
Quick! Okay. I think we got that. Yeah, okay.
Explosion.
We got that. Ooh.
Jump over the falling tree.
Whee!
Through the tree.
Oh! How did I not? Okay, I was doing well up until that tree decided to go, nope. Why didn't I jump the tree?
Rolling.
Man. Friggin' tree. Might play some Gran Turismo after this, I don't know.
Explosion.
Maybe I'd go faster if I took my pants off. What do you think?
Explosion.
Uh-oh. Can't see anything.
Explosion.
Oh, Christ. He's got ahead of me, that's not good. I was like, I'm pretty sure that ain't good. Also, who recognizes the line I just said? I'm intrigued. I don't know. Maybe I'd go faster if I took my pants off. What do you think? Oh boy. Here goes nothing.
Yeah.
Okay, I actually missed a checkpoint there. Uh-oh. We'll get there. One day, we'll get there. Worst thing is Live Twice for Tomorrow is just, like, worse. I'm lucky looking forward to doing that one. That's actually my favourite one. Even though it's tough as nails, and I will struggle, Live Twice for Tomorrow is my favourite film in the game. I like Toothless and Whopping as well. That's pretty good. Mainly because it doesn't consist of any hard stunts. It doesn't. I can't believe this is so difficult. 2002 this game came out, and it's still tough. Even now, it's hard. It's like, why? Okay, alright. I think we're getting there. That's the camera crew, yeah. I was like, I think I'm gonna die here if I keep going this way. I didn't turn hard enough.
Rolling. Action.
Also, I do apologize for not playing well, but it has been like 5 years, maybe longer than that, since I last played this game. So make of that what you will. 2-1-0. Okay, we're getting that nailed. This is good. Okay. Any one of these takes could be it. I just don't know which one. Woo! Okay, that was close. Sorry for the odd... I make some weird-ass noises. I just realized. Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ!
Uh-oh. Friggin', I don't care about that. Got you. Yes! I got it. 2-1-0. Okay. 3. No tree. Making it. I just died. Yeah.
Cut. Set him up again.
Oh my god. That was perfect! Oh my days. Benpire, this is not a good speed game. It's hard as hell. Trust me. Play through it first, you'll see how hard it is.
Rolling.
It's like blind chance you get this. You really have to practice this one though. Just to get a run, you'd have to practice every stunt, like, 20 times over. This has to be the worst one we've done so far. Like, I'm actually genuinely struggling with this. I can't actually beat this one yet. Turn, you friggin'... Uh-oh. This is a monster. Oh no, I'm not gonna make that. I made it. Okay, here we go. And explosion, yes. Okay, I'm fine if I turn this way.
Jump over the falling tree.
Yep, that's fine. Tree!
Through the trees.
Tree, okay, right. Let's just go that way. I don't even know where I'm going.
Smash through the snowman.
I'm not doing that.
Hit the micro light.
I can't hit that neither.
Stay ahead of the snowmobile.
I'll stay ahead of that. I'll try at least. Okay. Hopefully I do this without messing it up. Ah! Okay, right. Here goes nothing, I guess. Jesus.
Jump off the ramp and under the tree.
How am I supposed to do now?
Explosion. Avoid the snowmobile. Explosion. Smash into the barn.
Yes! Yes! Finally! Okay, I am skipping. I'm going to the next stunt. I don't even care. We're done. Oh.
It's okay.
Oh,
when
man.
When you're taking a dip, we use Lexan plastic as the windscreen and put bars behind it to stop it coming in on impact.
Gee,
divers nice. With cutting equipment and an air tank with an octopus breather all set to get you out if anything gets... complicated, and I'll have a mini air tank strapped down inside the car and an air regulator valve taped to my wrist too, just in case.
The one thing I will say, Benpai, is if you are going to try and run this, you need patience. A lot of it. And, like I said, practice every act, everything, from start to finish, just so you know exactly the whole game. For me, this is just playing it through for a bit.
The movie action here picks up from the previous sequence.
The sequel?
My character runs enough, speaking from the wreck of sequel, he's to the RV. He's chasing someone who just tried to kill him.
The sequel,
at the end of the stunt,
Stuntman Ignition, that's easier than this game. I'll be honest, I had an easier time with Stuntman Ignition. I found that more fun than this one. This one was a great game, but Ignition was better in my eyes because it was easier. That's the only reason I liked Stuntman Ignition more. But for originality, this was ace when it came out on the PS2 originally. I got the... Funnily enough, I got Stuntman Ignition before I got Stuntman, so I played the sequel before I played this one. Oh, I remember this.
Chase the RV! Through the bridge support. Let's work between the rocks. Explosion.
It was always weird for this. I just found this was odd.
Through the snowman.
Oh, hi.
Through the logs and back out of the river.
Oh my god.
Between the rocks. Down the waterfall.
I actually can't see where.
Where's the RV?
Driving off road, I don't care.
Around the island.
Around the island, okay. Yeah, Ignition was great, but I don't know. This one for me, I always used to be more hyped about this one. Okay, right. Here goes nothing, I guess.
Chase the RV through the trees.
I am doing. Chase.
Drift left.
Yeah, this felt like more of a movie game.
Through the trees.
I'll be honest, you don't really need anything else more than this one. Oh, Jesus. Ah! I thought I could get away with that. I actually thought I could get away with that. This one actually has a really tough end scene, by the way. So at the end of this particular scene, I don't know how I got away with that, but at the end of this particular scene, there is a bit where you have to hit a microlight, and it's awful. I like the moves and scenes more, yeah. I also tried routing Tokyo Race Driver 3, but it's like 6 hours. Seriously? I never do you know what? I've never finished any Tokyo Race Driver games. The only one I've actually finished was... what's it called? Grid. I finished the Grid series. Grid, Grid 2, Grid Ops 4. I haven't finished the new one because I haven't played it. I haven't got it. No, I played it. I don't actually own it though.
Through the logs and back out of the river. Between the rocks.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Christ. Oh, that was awful. Okay, I'm redoing that one. Fair to say, I'm definitely redoing that one. Yeah, I've finished Grid, Grid 2, Grid Autosport, but I've never done runs of any of them. I do plan on doing a run of Grid. I might do a run of Grid this year at some point. Hopefully. I've got Tokyo Race Driver 2. I haven't managed to find 3 anywhere. Picked Tokyo Race Driver 2 up, well, a year ago, 2 years ago, maybe. And my god, was it good. I say that. I picked it up for the PS2 a long time ago, and then I got it on PC, and I could never get it to work, actually. What I played. Oh my days. I didn't even get the snowman. Come on. Should have got the snowman then. The snowman. That is the one we want. The snowman. Friggin' Frosty.
Rolling.
I'm gonna get him.
Action.
The Feels like I'm all Swiss now. I have absolutely no idea. Oh, Sebastian Buemi. I did not hit him. I did not. Oh, hi, Sebastian Buemi.
Explosion.
Oliver, but yeah, I suppose. I don't know who that is, but I guess so. If he's Swiss. Sebastian Buemi, because he's Swiss. I got it. Yes. Check me out. Oh, boy. Uh-oh. Ah! Damn it! God damn it. Hopefully we'll be finished before like midnight. This'll be nice.
Rolling.
The oh yeah guy. I think who it is now.
Chase the RV.
Doesn't ring a bell.
Through the bridge support.
From yellow. I don't think I've seen that.
Swerve between the rocks.
I'd probably like recognize it if I heard the oh yeah, but fair. Or is it, oh yeah, is it him?
Explosion.
Is it that song? Oh yeah.
Left,
oh, that song! Yeah. Right. Oh yeah.
Through the logs and back Between the rocks.
Okay, right, between the rocks. Here we go. Yeah. Down the waterfall.
Chase the RV.
Ah. Christ. Was Einstein Swiss? I don't know. I don't remember. I thought Einstein was German, wasn't he? Oh no. No. Sorry, not Einstein. Isaac Newton. No, way off. Neither of them were German, were they? I don't remember either of them guys being German. Maybe they were, I don't remember.
Through the trees. Into the cable car.
I missed!
And cut.
80%. Right, so I need to hit him. Do I have to aim to the right? I need some more speed for that one. That is literally hit and miss.
Rolling.
Okay, time to do it all again.
And action.
I think getting that bit at the end is difficult. Oh, it's Scarab of the Lost Souls after this, I think. Which is good. Because Scarab of the Lost Souls is actually difficult. So to some extent, it's easy, but difficult too. Although Slow said it was a lot easier than, what's that other one? The Live Twice for Tomorrow. Live Twice for Tomorrow is hard, but is my favourite, because it has some great stunts in it. Not easy, so to speak, but not, like, unbelievably difficult. Ooh, did I get it? Yes.
Down the waterfall.
Ooh.
Chase the RV!
And I go over there. Hiya, fellas!
Around the island!
Also, if you look for a video on YouTube, it's still there. It's been on YouTube now for like 15 years? No, that'd make it possible. I think it's been on YouTube since like 2007 or something. Basically, there's a video which is Driver 3, worst crash ever, or worst Driver 3 crash ever. And it's the music from this is in the video. And they put it with like the Matrix Reloaded car chase music. Oh, it's so funny. I'll happily take a 8%.
Into the cable car.
Yes!
Cut.
Yeah! Got it. Okay, so you need some speed for that one. So I got a tuk-tuk and a big-ass truck. Oh, no. It's the monster truck one! Now I forget about these things between. I forget about these stunts between films. I'm not doing too bad so far, to tell the truth.
Monster Truck Mayhem.
This should be interesting. I actually struggled with this one. Let's see how I do. Funnily enough, you can do that and it still counts. This is going well so far. I'm very impressed that it is going well. Yes! First try! Oosh. Nice. And I got the monster truck. Nice. Okay, film number 5. Scarab of Lost Souls. Cairo, and Luxor, Egypt. Good film, this one. This is basically an Indiana Jones ripoff.
We're gonna flip the Jeep with a cannon roll on this movie. This one's a little more unusual because at the same time as we flip it, we're going over a timed explosion. I'm gonna activate the explosion myself from a button on the steering wheel.
Nice. Are you ready? It's the first one of the day. First act of the Scarab of Lost. There's 4 acts in this, by the way.
This is an adventure story. I play the hero, Dakota Scott. He has to find the ancient scarab before the bad guys, or it's bad news for everyone. I'm in the Jeep and have to get to the temple where the scarab's been taken. The only way there in time is through the town. And it's garrisoned.
It's garrisoned. This was actually the demo level, by the way. If you ever played the Stuntman PS2 demo, this was the level you played. So prepare to go back to those days of PS2 demo discs in a minute. And it loads.
Scarab C-19, take 1.
Here we go.
Straight ahead. Hit the checkpoint.
Even the music's like, you can tell the music's supposed to be Indiana Jones.
Hard left, hit truck. Smash pass through stalls. Through marked stalls. 180 handbrake. Close to explosion. 180 handbrake. Jump the steps.
I thought it's a cool robot.
Late handbrake turn.
Scarab, they call it Scarab stalls. Yeah. What things.
Explosion.
Shut round, step on it. Into match stalls.
Jump into stall.
That better remember.
Head right. Through gap. Cannon roll. Cut.
First try. 100%. Boom. That's a new car, a new arena try. Actual first try as well. I know. Hundo, first try. Let's go. Types are cool roleplay artists, but the Mario Extension said no, especially related to the story of S on LS. That's strange. It's weird. Nightbot hasn't come up. Nothing's cool for
this
it being.
This sequence begins as
deleted.
A chase, leading out of town through a minefield, then a big canyon jump. This stunt ends with me lining up the car with the pillar, accelerating, then jumping out before impact.
Don't remember this one being fun. I could be wrong, but, you know. Also, I should just mention something as well. The delay between me playing it and you guys seeing it on screen is about 1.5 seconds. So I do apologize that... what is it? I do apologize that what I'm doing might be different. Like, I might play something today. Coming up there. Well, that's a second difference, but still.
Between the trucks. Through the market.
Okay, right. I'll restart that one because I messed up badly. Dr. Scott, the Germans have found my house. I'll have to roll with you. You can call me Abdul the Sentinel if you want. Why do I have a feeling I know that name from somewhere?
Action! Chase the staff car!
Now it's going through me and it's like, what is that? What's that name? That sounds very familiar.
Between the trucks!
Oops. Just took the truck out by accident. Whoops! Didn't mean to do that. Take three. Also, look at the time we've got in the bottom left. Good God.
Between the trucks. Through the market.
No.
Flip truck.
Hey, truck.
Smash through
rigged
hut.
Excuse me.
Explosion. 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 Towards the bridge. Tank shell.
Tank shell? I don't want tank shell.
Jump the canyon. Smash through rigged hut. Explosion. Through the jerry cans. Line up the pillar. Accelerate before you jump. Cut, you've damaged the lead vehicle.
How did I do that? You've damaged the lead vehicle. Well, that's what's supposed to happen, isn't it? Oh well. Gotta do it all again. Yeah. I messed up the some of the jumps too. Also, this theme song would have put John Williams to shame, wouldn't it? Those that don't know who John Williams is, he's the guy that wrote the Indiana Jones soundtrack. The theme song, I mean. I also think you just barely missed the target percentage. Yeah, probably did. I think there's a white line, isn't there? There, there, white line at the top, yeah. That's the pass, right? Chase the staff car. Oh boy. I really suck at that, I keep hitting that. So I'd walk away to Scarab and Lost Souls. The Germans went to Abdul's house, he offered them some baba ganoush, and the Germans felt it was too salty to... So they decided to kick him out. Action. Chase the snap car.
Between the trucks. Through the market. Flip truck.
Oh, hello.
Cut. Get another vehicle ready.
Ouch. Yeah, I may have hit that one. Oh, God. Oh, God. That's better. Oh, God. No, no, don't fall over. Ow. That's better.
And rolling.
And off.
Action.
Weirdly enough, actually. No, Tato, I have a question. Do you know what baba ganoush means? As in, do you know what it is? Because I don't, and I really want to know. It'll become apparent why, I just need to be told what it is. Does anybody here know what that means? So, slight touch.
That.
Eggplant dip. Is that what it is? I did not know that.
Explosion! 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 Towards the bridge! Tank shell! Tank shell! Swerve left to jump the canyon! Smash through rigged hut! Explosion! The jerry cans. Line up the pillar. Accelerate before you jump.
That might be why I did it. Also, yes. That might be why I failed it, because I hit the pillar, and I think the pillar fell on the car and the car got wrecked or something. That's probably why it said don't hit the lead vehicle. Or the car hit something else. So here we go. With the camera mode. It's an eggplant dip. I've never tried it personally, but I'm quite curious to see what it tastes like. The reason I ask, and the reason why that's important, is because when I was in high school... Yeah, when I was in high school, there was these bunch of lads that were in my English class, and they used to call me Baba Ganoush, and it really pissed me off, because I didn't know what it meant. And I didn't bother looking it up or anything like that. And they used to say baba ganoush like that. And it really used to annoy me. And you said it again, I'm like, what actually is it? Because they wouldn't tell me. Because I said, what is it? And they went, you're a baba ganoush. And I'm like, what's a baba ganoush? The fact that they've been saying you're an eggplant, that's quite funny, actually. I mean, they're idiots anyway, but it's just funny. You know, you say, no, it's just an eggplant. I'm like, oh, okay. Poor truck. Nice. Through the hut. Round the ball. There we go. Nice. But yeah, that's the whole reason as to why I asked, like, what it's about. Well, not what it's about, what it is. I was intrigued. Also, there's a bike one that involves a jump. I don't like the bike ones.
Dakota Scott's Jeep's blown up and he's got hold of a motorbike. Here, I'm trying to find a way into the temple, coming under fire from everywhere. They know I'm coming. I need to finish here with a jump over a reservoir, the armored car falling into it behind me.
I forget how this one works now. Well, we're gonna find out pretty hard. We're gonna find out how bad this actually is. Here we go.
Scarab, scene 35, take one. And action.
Motorbike time. I don't like anything on two wheels or more, I don't like.
Through sentry gate, cut. Reset.
Oh. Where are you going? I don't know. Where's this supposed to go? Should have just followed that one, I think. Yeah, slow ride, are you enjoying this? You're like, when are you doing a Stuntman playthrough? I'm like, how about now? I hadn't actually played it through for years, so it's a good job I brought it up or mentioned it. Oh, Jesus. Well, that's bad. Yeah, I just found out the hard way as you said that. Super extra careful on the jumps. Yeah.
Take three. And action.
How many stunts is there in this one? Three? Five, I mean. Okay, through there.
Swerve right off the jump.
Oh, Jesus, come on. How are you supposed to do that? Right, so you've got to go up there. Hang on, wait. Overtake him on the left. Through the bump. Jump, but you have to jump that way. How are you What's that?
Rolling.
What's that jump about?
Action.
Ah, whatever.
Overtake the lead truck. Through sentry gate. Swerve right off the jump.
I'm done now. Ooh, ooh. Holy crap, this is slow.
Round the far pillar.
Oh boy.
Through
oh boy.
Entrance, up the steps with the jump.
Yeah, I took the front wheel off. This one's going to be a pain, isn't it? The fourth one's hard as well, because you have two fire points where you've got to fire. One's firing the tank, and the other one's to blow up the actual submarine, I think it is. Because that's a stunt in this game. That apparently counts, according to this.
Around the far pillar. Temple entrance, up the steps for the jump.
Just gonna do that. Well, obviously I've failed that explosion. Jesus.
Between the trucks.
No. Friggin' hell. Christ. So not only do you have to be good on a bike, you have to be good at dodging shit too. Christ on a bike. Literally.
Add action. Overtake the lead truck.
I have a horn.
Through
yes. I think I have a horn.
Right
woo. Hey, right round.
Round the far pillar.
Round the far pillar.
Gotcha. Through the temple entrance. Up the steps for the jump.
I'll do that. I guess that
explosion.
Works. Okay, I just about missed that.
Left. Between the trucks.
And through the trucks.
Through the crates.
Oh.
Accelerate hard for the jump.
I am doing. Oh, Christ, didn't make it.
God, that's the wrong way.
Also, I fell off. You said don't fall off, I just did. Only after I crashed, though. God, this one's all over the place. How are you supposed to know where you're going next?
Rolling.
I'm being honest, the music I liked the most in this game was actually... Okay. I mean, let's not keep going with that one. The music I liked the most in this game was Toothless and Whopping. Whooping and a Hollering. And... Live Twice for Tomorrow. Live Twice for Tomorrow has some pretty good music. I'm not gonna lie.
Overtake the lead truck.
Pretty good.
Through Sentry Gate. And swerve right off the jump.
Oh, come on, go. Cut. Where are you going?
Fire pillar.
I'm not going around the fire pillar.
Up the steps for the jump. Explosion.
Don't care if I miss that one.
Left. Between the trucks.
Nah.
Through the crates. Accelerate hard for the jump.
Yeah! Made the jump.
Right, just smash through the barrels.
Where am I going now? Oh, Jesus. Around the back of the shot, I guess.
Between the barbed wire. Hit the machine gun.
I've hit everything.
Use the ramp to get on the roof. God, that's the wrong way.
Oh, this could be a hard one. I could be here for a while with this one, chaps. I can't lie. Ah, my legs. I've had my legs crossed. Ah. God, that didn't that half hurt when I stretched them. You know when you get to that point where you just start going nuts, like... Any day now, I might finish this game. I'm pretty sure I can finish this game in under 4 hours.
The fire pillar.
I mean, I made that a challenge, but I don't know, maybe I could actually do that.
Explosion.
Oh, get the explosion, nice.
Left. Between the trucks.
And through that.
Through the crates.
This actually seems to work quite well, because that bit on the left seems to be a lot nicer.
Between the barbed wire.
I made that. How the hell did I make that?
Use the ramp to get on the roof.
I took the fucking wheel off, didn't I? Of course I did. Of course I took the wheel off. Any day now.
And rolling. Action.
Also, surprisingly, in a little under 2.5 hours, we've nearly finished this game. Like, that's not even faking it. Oh, crap. I'll go with it at this point. I'm not even bothered.
Around the fire pillar.
I have damage.
Through the temple entrance, up the steps for the jump.
Am I supposed to hit those off? Hey, Mike. Oh crap, I've missed that. Yeah, I missed that. Come on. Between
the trucks.
Between them.
Oh,
got him.
Through the crates. Accelerate hard for the jump.
Oh, the jump! Alright, I made it.
Right, just smash through the barrels.
Okay. Barrels. Left. Oh, crap, without running people over. Here we go. The hardest bit of this friggin'... I didn't even hit that. I did, actually. No, I didn't hit that. Tell why I didn't hit that. Oh. I don't want to get on the roof.
Jump the gap.
Now.
Go blind left down the slope.
Jesus Christ.
Through the crates, through the gap.
I made it! I don't know how.
Cut. Too slow.
Right near the end, and I died. I say died, I got game over. God damn it! Fuck me, this game's hard. There, I finally said it, this game is hard.
Rolling.
Now I'm kind of like, I don't want to speedrun this in the future.
Overtake the lead.
Unless I'm prepared to spend 4 hours on one single mission.
Through sentry gate.
I did say before, didn't I, that it's all about practice though. So if I just practice, I mean, hey, this isn't a game that you're good at in one go. Although, a speedrun is like that.
Explosion.
Okay, I made that explosion. Don't know how.
Between the trucks.
Give me a break. Yeah, exactly. It'd be good if you... I mean, if we had a... You could have them as miscellaneous categories, I suppose. I don't see why not. I mean, they could be miscellaneous, you know. Ooh! Holy crap, I made that. Okay, well, let's keep going. The steering on this is friggin' dreadful. How does a bike handle so bad? Sorry for bike fans, by the way. Woohoo! Simon Crown, oh yeah. Can't forget our Simon. I will hopefully do him justice later, yes. He just sat there like, hey, how's it hanging? How you doing that jump again? Yeah, huh? It's like the sixth time today, but okay. Norris Natato, thank you, Snowtato, sorry. Thank you for the follow and for sticking around as well. I really appreciate it. And feel free to come back anytime.
Hit the machine gun.
Ooh, okay. Hit the friggin' machine gun. Come on. There we go.
Use the ramp to get on the roof.
Oh boy.
God. Hey, are you okay?
I nearly did it then. Oh, this is painful. Come on. I'm not going to have an easier time with Live Twice or Tomorrow either.
Rolling.
Actual concern for the stuntman. No way. That's the first time I've actually knocked him off the bike and gone, are you alright? I do believe in a stuntman film, as in a... as an actual stuntman, I believe that the director's like, you alright? Yeah.
Explosion.
Great game, a bit frustrating
between
times.
The
I mean, it's already getting me at this level right now, James, so...
Accelerate hard for the jump.
Make it! Oh,
right,
man.
Just pass through the barrels.
I'm getting closer with them jumps, my god. If I go too far, it goes, where are you going? So I need to be careful. Okay, can I get jump? Did I break the game? I'm doing it, see? Where is... wait. Is the game gonna stop me? Or not?
God, that's way too
what? Excuse me? Game, you broke! It wasn't my fault you broke. I broke the game. How did I break it? Did I do things too quick? Did it not load in? I don't know. Well, whatever. That's a first. I've never done that before. Same engine as Driver. Yeah? I think it's the same engine they used for Driver 3. I can't quite remember, actually. Although you can tell that this game... the assets from this game were in Driver 3. There's a police car in Wolfen and a Hollerin. And basically the sound effects, the siren, sorry, is for the police car in Miami, in Driver 3. So yeah, make that what you will. So, hey dude, let's do this. Please make it! Okay, we made it over the jump.
Right,
here we go. Boom, straight through the barrels, then left, around the back of the crew. Okay, the game's not broken, this is good.
Between the barbed wire.
Okay,
use the ramp to get on the roof.
Use the ramp to get on the roof. Check.
Jump the gap.
And I'm off.
Cut, wrong way.
Hey, fell off at the end. Yay. I got it like upside down. He's still like that. Oh, gone. Now eventually just goes. Oh, I love broken rolling physics sometimes. These games are brilliant. As tough as they may be. Yeah, exactly. Every single stunt would be like, you wouldn't get these in the first try anyway, would you? Friggin' hell. Missed that first one. The furthest I've got is right near the end when you go through that gap, and that's it. That's the furthest I've got. And I messed that up. I got through the gap, actually, and then that was it.
Overtake the lead truck.
Well, I've done this one that many times.
Like,
I'm getting there now. I'm actually learning the game better because I've failed it that many friggin' times. Live Twice for Tomorrow's gonna be a laugh though, because you'll get to see me really struggle. That game's not like that. That film isn't even bad either. Like, that film's great. Yeah, I do. I think it's great. Not to mention the theme song for this. Like, I'm not joking, but come on, even John Williams would be passionate about this. No. I couldn't even pause then. Come on. Back to the beginning again. The worst thing is you do one act and you mess it up right near the end and it's like, nope, back to the start again.
Rolling.
I've heard this theme so many times though. I want to go insane.
Overtake the lead truck.
Yeah, Live Twice for Tomorrow's actually.
Through sentry gate. Swerve right off the jump.
Okay. Bike's slightly damaged.
Round the far pillar.
Should be fine.
Through the temple entrance. Up the steps for the jump. Explosion.
Explosion.
Left. Between the trucks.
Come on, come on, come on.
Through the crates. Accelerate hard for the jump.
Right, ooh! Okay.
Right, just smash through the barrels.
Okay, we're getting there. We are getting there. Oh, hi. Hey.
Between the barbed wire.
Jesus.
Hit the machine gun.
Hit
use
that.
The ramp to get on the roof.
How about... yeah? Okay.
Jump the gap.
There isn't even like power.
Go blind left down the slope. Through the crates. Through the gap. Right, up the steps. Armored car, turn right. Stay clear of the debris. Jump over the reservoir.
Holy crap! I only just made that! Bloody hell! How the hell? Okay, next. Get me off that one.
One of the key lessons about stunts is to plan. We get our toy cars out and work everything through.
They should have done DLC for the movies like in detail before Sun Battles, The Revenge of the Jody, and Jim Blonde. You can to eliminate chance. We'll just edit London out, yeah.
Keep planning till you plugged up every hole you can find.
Oh, God. Yeah, we'll just edit that bit out. The final film's like, and jump! Oh, God. That would be quite funny. I thought the game got stuck then. I was like, please don't get stuck. Please. Okay. Oh.
Dakota Scott escapes interrogation and knows the Scarab's been taken to the U-boat bound for Germany. He steals an armored car to stop it leaving, causing mass destruction on his way. For the ending, I need to jump right into the rigged conning tower of the submarine to sink it.
Alright, well, this one is going to be some finale. I'm pretty sure you can get this pretty decently, providing you don't screw it up too bad. Then we get another stunt thing, and then we have Live Twice for Tomorrow. So hopefully we get past this, the stunt thing, and we move on to Live Twice for Tomorrow.
Scarab, scene 44, take one.
Where are we going?
Add action through the entrance.
Oh.
Left around monument.
Oh, left around one. Okay. Sweet Jesus. Hey.
Box. Through the ammo boxes. Aim at pillar and fire.
Did they get it?
A narrow gap.
Oh, well, I didn't get that, did I?
Up pillar and out.
Whee! Oh boy. Yeah, I don't think I'm doing that one, am I? Yes, that tank could definitely go that fast. It's most likely hollow. Anything it hits, just...
Take two.
Take two, here we go. Move it. The thing is, this is way off. You have to really hit
the ammo boxes. Aim at pillar and fire.
Also, I'm gonna aim and hopefully fire. Yes, I am.
A narrow gap.
And I'm gonna hit that tank.
Up pillar and out. Jump down.
Jesus Christ. Two.
Through rigged hut.
Through the rigged hut? Okay, I can do that.
Overtake truck.
Ow. Oh, I see.
Explosion.
Oh, too slow. That was going to be one of two things. One, where are you going? Two, yeah, one would be, where are you going? And two would be, you failed it. It really, right, so I have to get, hang on. I have to, oh, I don't know.
We're
already at three takes, Jesus. I ain't got like halfway through this one yet. You know it's good when you start getting more and more all the way through. It's going to take a while, but we'll get there. The worst one has to be the last mission. The last stunt. Stop the stealth drop. Awful. Oh, crap.
God, you missed.
I forget you can also do that quite easily if you don't line it up. Second half of this one, real not bad at all. I'd hope so. Turbo powered car. I think we've already done that one. Or have we? Yeah, I think we've already done that one. I think.
Through the ammo boxes. Aim at pillar and fire.
Oh crap. No, I missed that. Yeah, we've done that one. It's in Blood Oath, it's the tuk-tuk chase. You got that little three-wheeler thing, and it... Yeah.
And rolling.
Yeah, we got past that one. It took a while to get through that, to be fair. Not as much as it's doing with these ones, but my god. Oh, hello.
Left around Monument.
Not what I wanted to do. No, that is definitely not what I wanted to do. Come on, tank. Bloody hell. Go a bit faster.
Through the ammo boxes. Aim at pillar and fire.
He does say that...
Narrow gap. Jump down.
Yay! Making it. Come on. 5, 4. Okay.
Overtake truck.
I'll overtake him on the right. I don't really care.
Explosion.
Where's the...
Through brake cut. Pass through the trucks for the jump.
Okay.
Take off the wing.
Take off
avoid
the wing.
The wrecks.
1-0. Oh, okay. Oh, boy.
Smash through the wall into the town. Through the market stalls. Hard right. Take the corner off the building.
Then more than just take the friggin'...
Dark wall.
Yes! Yeah! Nice! Done it! Yeah! Done. Ooh! That's a nice looking thing. I don't know what it is, but I like it. Okay. Done. One more. World record attempt. Last two-thirds is actually pretty hard. Everything past the ramp of the two trucks.
A new world record attempt. Now with the aid of nitrous oxide, we're hoping to double the current world record and jump a distance just over 140 meters. That's a massive 460 feet. The Stuntman is looking to clear 36 buses. Side by side.
Bloody hell.
And if that's not enough for you, we're going to add a loop right at the start.
Jesus. Oh Christ. So this is a loop-de-loop and turbo power? Gee whiz. Freaking hell. Oh God. Oh boy. Oh, never like this. Yeah, first try. Yeah, and that is how you do it. Damn, poggers on that one. Friggin' hell. Yeah. Oh, mate. I made mincemeat of that one. I don't even know how I did that, but okay. Whatever. Live twice for tomorrow. Monaco. This is the hardest set of stages in the entire game, but it's really good.
As a general rule, you shouldn't do any stunt you're not prepared to do two or three times. If the safety threshold isn't high enough for two attempts, it's not high enough for one. That's the difference between a stuntman and a daredevil. Daredevils don't know if they're going to make it.
Monaco, time to try and make Hamilton hit a wall. Not in this one, you don't. So basically, Live Twice for Tomorrow is a 007 ripoff. And the guy who is supposed to be James Bond is called Simon Crown. The entire film is basically a 007 ripoff.
This is the new Simon Crown movie. Doubling for Crown like I'm doing now is a lifetime ambition for most stunt people. Budgets and pressure don't get much bigger. This part of the story is set in the mountains over Monaco, Crown giving chase. In the last part of the scene, the car in front explodes and I need to swerve and jump the gorge.
So, also has some kick-ass music. I know you had Dak Carter. So you got some pretty good music too with this one. Live Twice for Tomorrow. That makes no sense. I know. You not missed all of it, Cole.
Live twice. Scene six. Take one. Chase the sports car. Get close to the oncoming car. Get close on the left and overtake. Get close on the left and overtake.
Restart. Nice to have a bit of power and grip, yeah, apart from when I drive like that. Didn't last too long, but then again, these stunts are hard. These levels are hard. We might have a bit of trouble with these.
Take two. Chase the sports car. Get close to the oncoming car. Get close on the left and overtake.
Thing is, I can't hit that car either. I'm not allowed to hit it. Not allowed.
Get close on the left and overtake. Get close on the left and overtake. Over the bridge.
Ooh.
Swerve to avoid the truck. God, that's too
slow.
Good
grief. Okay, I got completely side-gunned there by a truck. Nice. That roll had style. Hell yeah, it did. You get style points in Stuntman. You don't get money. You get stunt points. I wish. I wish that was the case.
Get close to the oncoming car. Get close on the left and overtake.
Get us another car, yeah. This is basically what can only be described as an Aston Martin. Don't know which one though. Vanquish? Yeah, it's a Vanquish, isn't it? Let's be honest.
Get close on the left and overtake. Over the bridge. Swerve to avoid the truck.
Damn it. The movie screams Johnny James Bond. The music screams Johnny English, yeah. It's a mix between the two. I mean, look at that. That's even telling you what the film's about. It's an Austin Burton, copyright friendly.
And rolling. Chase the sports car. Get close to the oncoming car. Get close on the left and over.
Ah! Friggin' spun out again. Christ almighty. Sounds like a name of a car Austin would actually make back in the day, yeah. Nah, that's definitely an Aston. Like, let's be honest. Oh crap. I can actually look to my left and my right. I didn't know I could do that. I mean, it's pointless because you're looking forward, you're not looking behind you. You don't need to, do you?
Get close on the left and overtake.
Worst bit about this one. Oh.
Get close on the left and overtake.
No.
Over the bridge. Swerve to avoid the truck.
Right. Just have to avoid the traffic here. Same as he's doing. And there's two trucks.
Go between the trucks.
Frame rate, huh? Come on. Where am I?
Keep left and make the jump. Cut.
I did it! 100% as well. I got everything on that one. Nice. Okay, I want to watch the replay. Let's actually have a look. Some of the stunts don't make sense considering there's nowhere for the other car to turn off. The stuntman should just drive where he wants. True. There you go. He gets seen behind what it actually looked like in the film. I love this. When you watch it back, it actually shows you it back as how it's actually going to look in a film. Not just your typical crappy camera mode. It's like, no, it's how it actually looks in a film. A bit of extra driving actually makes it look better, you know, going like out of my way to overtake cars. Maybe. I know you can make your own stunt thing, but it won't be too great. I was going to say, the back looks like a Vanquish. The front end looks more like a... back end looks like a Vanquish, the front end looks more like a Maserati of some kind. Although the yellow one, that just looks fucking ugly. It looks like a Ford concept car of some kind. Really crappy sport. Honestly, I don't like that yellow car at all. We do drive it, but I don't like it at all. I think it's an awful looking car. Probably it's one of the fastest cars in the game, but it's just awful. I really don't like it at all. I think it's friggin' dreadful. Nice. Yeah, exactly. Also, I like that. Right at the end. Flip it upside down as you do. It's based off a DB. Oh, yeah. It is actually. Yeah. I can see why they say that. Yeah, the DB7. Because the DB7 looks a lot like that. I forgot about that. He did? I think he drove a DB7 at one point. This is obviously a Lamborghini Diablo. Let's be honest, that's a Lamborghini Diablo in blue.
It fires into the rock face, and I have to avoid the boulders falling down. To complete the sequence, I need to guide the car off a cliff into the helicopter, diving out at the last second.
Or an Esprit. Yeah? An Esprit or a Lamborghini Diablo. We'll know when we see its back end. I think it's a Diablo. But now that you say Esprit, I have a feeling it isn't Esprit. There you go. And it loads. Oh, man.
Left twice, scene 9, take 1.
Also, for anyone that doesn't recognize this music, this music's from the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. I don't know how many people know this, but it actually is. It's from the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. You're probably like, which bit? The bit where he goes, who are you? And he's like, I'm David Hasselhoff. Because he says, it's like, who are you? I'm David Hasselhoff. Or something. I forget, what does he say in the film? It's like, how are we going to get to Bikini Bottom now? And he's like, I could take you there. Instead, David Hasselhoff with his Baywatch outfit on. And this is the actual music they used. It was available in Stuntman. They just ripped it and put it in SpongeBob movie. Freaking damaged the car already. God damn it. But yeah, for those that didn't know and whose minds are like, boof. Yeah, you're welcome. I didn't actually know until I read the comments for a video on someone. Isn't this the music that's in...
Take three.
Yeah, isn't this the music that's in the SpongeBob SquarePants movie? And I'm like... Huh. Oh, well, Slow Rider's correct, not me. Slow Rider is correct.
Get close to the explosion. Get close and overtake on the right. Get close and overtake on the left. Get close to the explosion. Get close and overtake on the left. Get close to the explosion.
This actually is quite difficult.
Jump over the destroyed bridge.
Jesus.
Okay, right. The car's going over backwards.
Cut. You wrecked the vehicle.
Oops. That was going well, too. That was going really well. I always love that Reflections cars were always really close copies. Yeah, exactly. How the hell they got away with half the cars they did in Driver? I have no idea how. I'm not gonna lie, I really like this music.
Get close to the explosion.
Come on, go, go, go!
Get close and overtake on the right. Close and overtake on the left.
Okay, I got a red mark. It's
get
fine.
Close to the explosion. Get close and overtake on the left.
Oh, crap. Okay, let's not do that. Let's not do that. Let's go back to the start and redo it all again. This one's actually a fun... It's going to sound stupid. This one's actually a fun little stunt to do. There's five altogether in this one. And this is act number two. I think the third act is my personal favourite. Because the third act involves a BMW of some kind. I'm pretty sure it's a BMW. And if it isn't, then it definitely is in my eyes. Okay.
Get close and overtake on the right. Get close and overtake on the left. Get close to the explosion.
Is it act four? This is... Oi! Ah! Hi! Jesus.
Get close to the explosion.
Stay ahead of the chocolate. Oh, no. I can't remember. We'll find out. We'll find out. Honestly, I forget how hard this game is. I do have Stunt Ignition. It's on my 360 though. I did have it on PS2 at one point, but I got rid of it. Because I found out the 360 version was a thing and I was like, I'm buying the 360 version. So I bought it for like 3 quid. Macca! Thank you very much for the raid, man. Whoa! Just in time. Ow. Well, I'll say that. You see, you're just in time to start me raiding. Raiding, restarting on this one. But thank you very much for the raid, dude. How was your stream? And what were you streaming? If you don't mind me asking. Also, welcome all those from Macca's stream. I am VPG13 or Viper. I mainly do speedruns of racing games. However, today I'm having a day off. Instead, I'm playing through Stuntman, a really hard racing game for the PS2. This could potentially be a speedrun of mine that I might do in the future. Although, that's yet to be seen. Nearly made that. You gotta get some sweet? Yeah, no problem. So basically, how this game worked, for those that have never seen Stuntman before, You've got to face the four directions that the instructor gives you and be quick about it. The faster, the more you get through the films, the faster everything gets. It's a casual playthrough, so take it with a pinch of salt. It's going fine, yeah. Nothing bad's happened yet, although I've got, like, not far all the things at the moment. Whoa! Damn. Holy crap! Never done that before. Don't be a car, don't be a car. Holy crap. Bear with me.
Swerve through the rocks. Get close and overtake on the left.
Ah.
Bear with me. Oh. About 10 seconds. Jesus. Crap, I failed that.
Jump out of the car. And cut.
Ah, failed. Damn. It is hard. This is a hard game, very hard. This game was totally inspired by Bond. Now, basically, Stuntman is there's six films. There's Toothless in Whopping, which is like Snatch, if you've ever seen that film. It's like a Guy Ritchie film. So you've got like a crime film, but it's got comedy value, that sort of thing. You know, two gangsters and stuff like that. You've got A Whoopin' and a Hollerin, which A Whoopin' and a Hollerin is like your typical Dukes of Hazzard style film, that sort of thing. There's Blood Oath, which is like your Japanese film, you know, what's to do with the mafia, you know, what is it, the Japanese mafia. I forget what they're actually called. What are they called? Japanese mafia, I don't know. Somebody can tell me. The Yakuza, that's it. Yeah. So, there's Blood Oath, which is like a Yakuza type film, a Japanese film. The fourth one, Conspiracy, is kind of a thriller, horror sort of thing. The fifth film is called Dakota Scott and the Scarab of Lost Souls, or just the Scarab of Lost Souls. That's basically an Indiana Jones ripoff. And finally, we have Live Twice for Tomorrow, aka a 007 ripoff. As well as the music, everything is also that as well. I should probably mention something. I've just been saying this before you guys turned up. But the music you can hear currently for this level, this scene, is actually in the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. For those that have seen that film when they were about 8 or 10 or however old you were. So there's a part in, for those that have seen the SpongeBob SquarePants movie, prepare yourself. Right, so there's a part of the film where SpongeBob has to get back to Bikini Bottom, and he's like, how will I ever get back to Bikini Bottom now? And then David Hasselhoff comes on and he goes, I can take you there. Yeah, this is the music they use for that. Holy crap. Oh boy. Okay, I got a bit more time now.
Avoid the falling rocks. Swerve through the rocks. Get close and overtake on the left.
Jesus. Come on, 30 seconds. I can make this. Unless he goes, cut! Too slow. Okay, nearly there. Come on, a spray or whatever cars are supposed to be. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it.
Jump
don't miss
out
it.
Of the car.
Yes! Got it!
Does anyone want to see that again? Except not me driving? Oh, man. The Let's Play I saw said Blood Oath was based on things like John Woo films, example Hardball. It probably is. So, when you play something in view mode, view replay, it's shot like the film. So, this is how it looked in a film, supposedly. Well, the game's version of a film. Actually, looks pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. It makes you driving even how... Doesn't matter how crap your driving is, it makes it look 10 times better. Also, frame rate can dip here and there, just be aware of that, but... There you go. I got lucky with that, where it went like that, poof, and whacked on the tail of it. I thought it were gonna like go and flip over, but it didn't. The name's Crown, Silent Crown. Pretty sure that's one of the things he says in the trailer. You have to do this at speed also, ready? Here comes the big up of the film. I love it. The camera still keeps rolling. It's like, right, we gotta have a rolling shot, we'll be fine. It's like, nobody saw that. I love it. Ready? And the finale. Here we go. Here goes the finale. Boom! Yes! Next stunt, let's go!
The reason is you want knee pads that stretch down from your knees to your ankles.
And Crown jumps up, falls off the cliff, yeah.
Because shins are a real problem. They start flying up at 60 to 0 in less than a second, start snapping all over the place. Most of the stunt people I know have snagged a shin or ankle sometime. I've done the same one twice.
That sounds painful. Right, so we've done 2 acts out of 5. I think it's 5 acts, or maybe it's 6. Or is it 6 acts? Might be 6 acts. I do apologise, I think it is 6. Someone buy Cal Risk of Rain 2, please. I don't know what Risk of Rain 2 is, so... Sorry. There we go. What's the car? Oh no. No, hang on, it's loading. And here we go. Oh.
Simon Crowns left one of Gustav's men dead in a hotel laundry bag.
Yeah, it's the Fiat 501, fellas.
He charms his way into an attractive woman's little European car and persuades her to let him drive. In this sequence, I have to escape multiple
this is,
tails and finally stop.
What's that film called with the mini chase?
Drop.
Not the Italian job. The Bourne Identity, that's it. The Bourne Identity, where they have the Mini Cooper chase through France. Which is coincidental. Monaco's a borough of France, isn't it? I know it's another country, but I still class it as France. Just a bit further away. But yeah, there you go. Dying for our house. Ouch. Oh, Christ. Here we go.
Add action. Hard left.
Wow. Nice start. Okay, let's not do that. Shall we? Let's not do that. Okay, take two. The best thing is he actually counts how many attempts you've done, and after a bit he just goes rolling.
Take two.
There we go.
Action. Hard left.
Dude! Are you joking?
cut. Stick to the route.
Okay, right. So, I need to go out the end and then left. Okay. I thought I was being smart going that way. I was like, he's not going to cut the production. No, he does. If you go out of lines or you miss up shots, he's like, cut, forget it. Retake.
Take three.
Stop wasting film. Hey, this guy's got plenty of... Oh, God, hello. This guy's got plenty of film. We'll be fine.
Overtake on the right. Overtake on the left.
Oh! Poor car.
Narrow gap. Cut. Wrong way.
Okay, yeah, we're definitely restarting that one. Holy crap. God damn. Polo, well, I don't like Fiat 500 anyway, so these can get wrecked. I'm not fussed. But I don't like wrecking sports and supercars. Time to count how many times the Fiat disintegrates on touching anything. You notice he stopped counting attempts now. He's gone rolling. This is what he does.
Overtake on the right.
Overtake on the left.
Overtake on the left.
Narrow.
Narrow gap. Smash through the fence.
Jesus. Ah, give me a break. I'm stopping that one. Go on. I'm restarting that. Gee whiz. I was going to run out of time anyway. It's made out of paper mache. It is. It is.
Rolling.
Feel free to keep count of how many times I have to do one act. I don't really mind if you want to keep count.
Overtake on the right.
Should be in a fail meter,
overtake
really.
On the left.
Okay, then over there.
Narrow gap.
Because he can't fit through here. Ah.
Smash through the fence.
Whoa! You friggin' can't. Car, sir!
Cut, set it up again.
Yeah, if you get, if you're unfortunate enough, he can ram you. The police are very, you know, like in Driver, how the police go haywire on survival mode. Yeah, the police do that in this mission. This scene, no joke. They're way more aggressive here. He's like not that aggressive, but the rest of them are. Friggin' insane. I'm like, dude.
Overtake on the left.
Okay.
Right.
Also, you'll notice he's probably behind me.
Overtake on the right.
Ah! Hi!
Overtake on the left.
Where's the car? Oh.
Overtake on the right.
Shoot.
Overtake on the left.
I'd rather it say cut. But he won't say cut on that one. No, well, that's the first I've got. The worst bit is, at the end of this, you go whack and that's it. Zuska, hello. Hello, Mr. Streamer.
Rolling.
How do you do?
Action. Hard left.
One of the hardest
ones. Overtake on the right.
This film, I think.
Overtake on the left.
It's the hardest one we've encountered so far. Okay. Jesus! Friggin' hell! Yeah, well, that's... I'm playing it on actual PS2. That's why I'm playing it. So... I'm backwards early on the reason I'm stuck in.
Action. Hard left.
Come on, Fiat 500! I know you're stuck, but...
On the left.
It's fine. Go and keep going. Okay. Carson, please don't take me out. This car will disintegrate to a million bits, I've been told.
Overtake on the right. Overtake on the left.
Which is fine, I don't mind cars disintegrating. Okay.
Overtake on the right.
Oh, hello.
Overtake on the left.
Oh, damn it. Please.
Jump the fountain.
Jump the fountain. Done that.
Handbrake 180. Around the fountain.
Jesus. Oh, Christ. Through the table, quick! I'd say too slow, I'd imagine. At this point, anything's better than nothing.
And again!
Yeah.
God, that's too slow!
Bloody hell. Okay, we'll try that one again. It's an interesting game to me simply because it's technically different. It's impossible to complete on an emulator. Due to floating point accuracy, making levels and such. Yeah, Carl said he's tested it, apparently. Carl's played a little bit of it. I don't remember what mission he got up to. Yeah, Carl's mentioned about it to me. But I've never managed to get a PS2 emulator set up, so.
Overtake on the right.
Thankfully, I own this game on emulator. I own this game on console, so luckily that's how I'm playing it. As you can see. There it is. There's my copy.
Rolling.
Action. Right near the end of the game as well. I could give this to people to try and do. I'd actually like to see people try this. Blind. I mean, technically, that's what we're doing right now, right? Come on! 50-50-500. I don't like this car at all. Like, in real life, I absolutely hate this car. I think it's dreadful. It is just an awful car. Oh, dude. Send us your PS2.
Handbrake 180.
I mean, I would, Cal, but I need it, so, sorry, dude. Christ, this thing shifts, doesn't it?
And again. Left, down the steps.
This is it. This is the bit that the AI seems to really hate you. Because now, what happens is this.
Follow the path, tight corner.
Ah.
Accelerate for the jump. Line up the jump to the valve cut. You wreck the vehicle.
I got so close. So close. Holy crap. Also, oh Christ, I missed a lot. My console lot how locks of PS2 games, but works fine with PS1. Our outstanding is that besides... I'll pause that. Besides that rounding bug, PS2 floating operation rounding is the exact same as the 0/sharp on PSX2, but we don't know the circumstances for the error. It requires more research. A PS2 has atrocious load times. I actually have mine on, what's it called? Mine's a 70k PS2, PAL, and it has the fast disk speed enabled at the moment. That's why the disk speeds are able to be loaded a bit faster. I don't know how much difference it makes if you play this game on a 90k PS2. Not much, I'd imagine, but then again, I don't know. I don't have a 90k PS2. Well, I have a 90k NTSC PS2.
And again. Overtake on the right. Overtake on the left. Overtake on the right.
Come on, jump the fountain. Yes. No. Nailed it. Gosh. Frigging lagging this. Good God. It's bad. Ah! Hi! Keep going, keep going. It's fine. It's fine. Hiya! Hiya, copper. Where's he gone?
of the path. Tight corner.
Come on.
Accelerate for the jump. Line up the jump to the balcony. Accelerate.
That at the end is a bitch. I hate it. So bad.
And rolling. Action. Hard left.
Yeah, just calm it down a bit, the gamer.
Overtake on the left. Narrow gap. Smash through the fence. Right.
Jesus.
And again.
Oh.
Overtake on
Holy
the right.
Sh- Jesus.
Overtake on the left.
No, actually I don't, because unlike my life, this thing actually seems to be going well. I'm enjoying it.
Handbrake 180.
Seem to do quite well at that. Got it.
Cut.
Yeah. 100% as well. God. That took a while, didn't it? This is Monaco or fake Monaco? Eh, sort of. The speed test inspired the Ypres layout for the Monaco street track. Did it? Speed test Monaco on this game is the west part of the track. No happen there. True. That bit there could be it, actually. This is definitely that, right, that's definitely the Nobel chicane, the big chicane in Monaco, come on. This is definitely the real life Monaco. Also, that had, this is the one that had the spin. I still pulled this off 100%. Also, are you ready? Watch the police car, ready? Like, ah! I love it. Oh, it's so great. The fact that all the close calls were in this one too. Pretty good. The fact that that counts as well. There we go. Over the fountain. Flipped on its side. No biggie, but we flipped it back on all four. So, woo, hello fellas. Speaking of speed tests, try driving all of them. I've done one of them. In the past. I've not really done them properly though. That's when we have the checkpoints and stuff, isn't it? Yeah. The fact that this thing... Look how quick this thing is! Is this a drag car or an actual car? Yeah, not now after you complete stealth check, exactly, yeah. Yeah. Also, that's Tanner. Look in the driver's seat. Cal, look. Doesn't, please tell me that looks like Tanner from Driver 3. Come on. That's Tanner. That, there's no way that's not John Tanner. It's John Tanner. That's him. Okay, right. We just found something out. John Tanner is actually Simon Crown in this film. Okay. Is John Tanner's cousin once removed? This is the greatest thing ever. How much does he look like him? Is the Reflections game they made Driver 3 after? Maybe that was the starting model. I don't know. But it could be. It's my boy Johnny T.
This time, Crown this is the one I like. With the Omega circuit. This sequence is about chasing
I like
the
this one quite a lot.
Destroy it. It's only later Crown learns.
Because we have this BMW M3, I think
this
it is.
This is quite unusual in that near the end, I actually get out of the car and drive it by radio control.
Ah, Ben's streaming GTA Vice City. Nice. The Stuntman, the cutscenes does look like Tanner. Nice. Is it M5? A Snowtail. Snowtato, sorry. I thought it was M3. M5, that's right. Radio control is just code for a dev playing with camera.
56, take one. Left, down the steps.
You've got to be kidding. I didn't even get to the checkpoint. Oh, dear. Well, at least that wasn't too bad. Yeah, tail lights are the same, aren't they? Never noticed that. Until you mentioned it. Alright, BMW.
Along the pier, hit the boxes. Hit the tables. Right turn, down steps.
Oi, no, I got that. I got that game. I hit your tables. Friggin' dumbass. I hit your tables. Apparently that didn't count. Okay.
Take three.
Take three. You can tell he gets fed up straight away.
Left, down the steps. Along the pier, hit the boxes, hit the tables.
Ah.
Right turn, down steps.
Shoot.
Dodge the car.
I can do that.
Through the gap. Avoid
also,
whee! Cut, stick to the roof.
Alright, I couldn't resist hearing that, okay? There's water, I'm going to go in the water. If I fail somehow, I can just go in the water, it's fine. John Tanner, no! I just killed John Tanner. Well, he's not like Tommy Vercetti who dies in water. The unusually buoyant cars. I know, yeah. That car will just sink normally. Not in this game, they don't. Stuff it, I'm going for it.
Along the pier, hit the boxes, hit the tables. Right turn, down steps. Dodge the car. Through the gap, avoid the car. Overtake on the left. Through the gap. Chase the van. Through the barrier, jump. Stick with him. Through the gap. Jump.
Holy crap!
Cut, wrong way.
Boing. Yeah, exactly. Getting that lined up's hard. My favourite part is the radio control bit. Right near the end it goes, go into radio control mode. You don't actually press a button, it just happens.
Rolling.
I like it though, it's fun. Providing we get there.
Left,
jeez,
down the steps.
Christ, game. Frame rate. That's like, that's
hit
not
the
game capture doing that, by the way. That's
right
like
turn,
genuine.
Down steps. Dodge the car. Through the gap. Avoid the car. Overtake on the left. Through the gap. Chase the van. Through the barrier. Jump. Stick with him.
Okay.
Through the gap.
Yep.
Jump.
Come on, make it! Yes!
Stick with him.
Jesus Christ.
Uh-oh.
Oh, guess where that went? Where did that go? It landed on its roof and rolled into water. Well, car makes a nice boat.
Rolling.
I keep thinking, every time I hear this song, I keep thinking, freaking SpongeBob movie. Who are you? I'm David Hasselhoff.
Along the pier.
Because this is the music that was used in the film! Hard not to get it out of your head now that you've heard it. Who are you? I'm David Hasselhoff. Hooray!
Overtake on the left. Through the gap. Chase the van. Through the barrier. Jump. Stick with him.
There we go. Right.
Jump.
Please, please, please make it.
Stick with him.
Yes. One down. One to go.
Through the trailer.
No.
Through the cafe.
Come on. Ah, come on. That would have so gone through. If that landed on its wheels, we would have kept the scene going. These cars, the physics, the suspension's like really soft. They really like flipping over too.
And rolling.
Yeah, enjoy, by the way. Just, you know.
Left, down the steps.
Jesus. This is so freaking bad right now.
Hit the boxes.
Come on.
Hit the tables. Right turn, down steps.
I'm not even gonna make this. Nope. Oh. You get it right one day, you get it wrong the next. You get it right on one attempt, you get it wrong the other. Oh god. We haven't even got to the second half of this one yet.
Rolling.
Do you want to hear the best bit? This isn't even the hardest one. The hardest one is the stealth jet one.
Along the pier.
Which, believe it or not, I think there's another, and then there's the stealth jet.
Right turn, down steps.
The stealth jet is actually the hardest level in the game, because you have to hit targets constantly. And my god, you do not have time to breathe.
Overtake on the left. Through the gap.
You'll see what I mean when we get there.
Chase the van.
I run people over, I can't, according to this.
Through the barrier. Jump. Stick with him.
Stick with him. See that?
Through the gap. Jump.
I'm just gonna put my foot down, hope that it goes through and works alright.
Stick with him.
It landed on its wheels, but I had to reverse into a thing. Of course that would happen to me. We'll get there eventually. We will get there eventually.
Rolling. Left, down the steps. Along the pier.
How's everyone doing anyway?
Hit the tables. Right turn, down steps. Dodge the car. Through the gap. Avoid the car. Overtake on the left. Through the gap.
That's bogus. I hit that.
Chase the van.
Hell, it's all out there right now.
Through the barrier.
I, for the life of me, I can't remember if there's another thing after
Jump.
This.
Stick with him. Cut. Let's go again.
Why is it that the moment I land on the wheels, it says too slow? How are you supposed to get through that first jump without messing up the second? How do you do it? Is there a certain speed I have to... Because the thing is, if I slow down at any point during that, by the way, I hit that trailer. There's no way of getting past it. Bogus.
Left, down the steps.
3.5 hours to get it to finish this damn game. Not even that.
Right turn, down steps. Dodge the car. Through the gap. Avoid the car. Overtake on the left. Through the gap. Chase the van.
Let go of the gas pedal as soon as you get airborne. Oh, can do that. Try.
Through the barrier. Jump. Stick with him. Through the gap. Jump. Stick with him. Cut. Too slow.
That one actually could have worked. Yeah, that was because the car took its side. If it didn't tip on its side and flattened again, I could have gone over that and the other second jump. That's the worst jump. That's the worst bit.
Rolling. Left, down the steps. Along the pier, hit the boxes. Hit the tables. Right turn, down steps. Dodge the car. Through the gap. Avoid the car.
Why not?
Through the gap. Chase the van.
Without getting deflected at all by the truck's trails. I don't know. I can't concentrate because I'm trying to read chat and I can't do that whilst I'm doing a stunt.
And rolling.
I'm never gonna finish this.
Left, down the steps. Along the pier, hit the boxes, hit the tables. Right turn, down steps. Dodge the car.
I mean, pretty much, yeah.
Through the gap. Avoid the car. Overtake on the left.
I don't even care if I fell back.
Through the gap. Chase the van. Through the barrier. Jump. Stick with him. Through the gap. Jump. Stick with him. Through the trailer.
Ooh, the trailer.
Through the cafe. Chase the van. Close to the car.
Okay.
Close to the car.
Uh-oh.
Stick with the van.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, I don't think it has infinity mass. Because I just battered that black SUV. So was I. I was expecting Mario to break and all. That kind of made me jump.
Down the steps.
It made you jump more, Kel, if you played it, trust me.
Hit the table.
Oh, the AI chase cars, yeah, I can see why.
Dodge the car.
There we go.
Through the gap. Avoid the car.
Now, can the game play ball?
Overtake on the left. Through
Jesus.
The gap. chase the van.
I can't. I'll tell a lie. I can't. But but does it still work though?
Stick with him. Through the gap. Jump. Stick with him. Cut. Retake.
What was that game? Seriously. God, we've been stuck on this one act now for like 20 minutes.
Down the steps. Along the pier.
Well, I mean, if it runs on a PS2, it doesn't run great.
Right turn, down steps.
I mean, you can see for yourself how much it lags and stuff, frame rate wise. It does.
Avoid the car.
It does lag quite a bit, unfortunately. That's just what this game likes to do.
Through the gap.
I don't know whether that's because it's being captured off my old... My old gatto, or what? Could be a reason. Maybe, I don't know, but I have a feeling that maybe it's quicker to play this if you have a PS3. Pretty sure. Freaking hell.
Stick with him!
Also, Neon, thank you very much for the follow. Appreciate it. Actually gives that time to play.
Rolling.
As well. That's a good time to activate that, actually.
Left, down the steps.
For the most part, I do runs of Call of the Crew Rally and that sort of thing. I have actually done a run of Stuntman of the GBA and finished it. It took me about 5203 or something. It's on YouTube if you want to watch it. For those that are intrigued to see how fast the Game Boy Advance version finished, it can be finished way faster. The PS2 version is better, but the Game Boy Advance version is easier. Because it has a tutorial mode where it's like, here's some of the actual playthrough in the game. This is actually true, so the Game Boy Advance version has some stuff that you play through and it's like, yeah, okay, you can play through a bit. Okay, so slow down before I hit the jump. That's a good idea.
Through the trailer.
Okay.
Through the cafe. Chase the van. Close to the car. Close to the car. Stick with the van.
Don't be too slow. Got it! Yeah! Finally. Okay. Next stunt.
Closest I've come to eating it, probably when I was doing a cannon roll and I hit the ground so hard the roll cage collapsed around me.
Yeah.
I crushed a few ribs.
Exactly, yeah.
A couple of fire crews with cutting equipment got me out.
And your favorite stunt?
Well, it's always the next one you do. Never go into any stunt thinking anything else.
Reference to the remote control BMW from Dollar 7, and because John Tanner is important. It is! Cutscene, guys! John Tanner! Okay, you're definitely 100% convinced now, aren't you? Is this the last scene or not? I don't remember. Yeah, that's it, yeah. Final FMV, yeah, I was always talking about Nader. This is it! This is the worst bit of the game. Crown has one you think I've struggled so far, watch me struggle with this one.
With the Omega Circuit in his stealth jet. This is a frantic race against time. I end by crashing into the jet in mid-air, ejecting out in time on a parachute.
Oh boy. This is the hardest level in the game. Getting this first try, or getting this done, like, in one good shot is pretty hard. I think they used... Oh, that was it. For the 007 one, for the 007 one, Cal was referencing to...
Clip twice, scene 82, take one.
That was actually done in a different way. So that was done as, it's seen as remote control, but really there's actually a stuntman driving it.
Under the truck and out the other side. Smash tables. Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board.
So, whoop!
Down the jetty after the jet. Cut. What have you done to the vehicle?
That's a Lamborghini. That's a Diablo. That wasn't bad, actually. I did alright with that one. Stuntman's dead. I know, yeah. Eventually, land upside down.
Take two. Action.
This one is hard. This one I do remember being very difficult. Simon I don't know.
Under the truck and out the other side.
Hi.
Smash tables.
Oh! Yeah, I'm restarting that. So I have to get close enough to catch the truck, but fast enough that I'm not hitting that. We're going to have a fun time getting through that main bit. Overtakes into the pole, yeah. So, that's the one.
Under the truck and out the other side.
This one is really difficult.
Smash tables.
Okay, go. I think we got it,
Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board.
Ooh! Cut. Well, we found that, yeah. Closest I've gone to eating it, cue yellow supercar rolling upon impact to the diving board. Yeah, so the guy that the stuntman that you play as is called Vic, for those that don't know. He doesn't actually say his name, but judging by the fact that the game gives you the default name as Vic, you'd have to presume so. I mean, hey, let's friggin' go. Let's do this. Let's film this piece of crap. I'm doing that. I don't care. We're still going for this. Okay. This is the last, don't worry, this is the last one of the, this is the last one of the, what's it called? Oh, you think it's unsafe now? Wait till you get to, like, halfway back. Friggin' hell. This one is tight. It's tight on time limits, it's tight on everything. Tobias Jones is the manager. I'd like to speak with your manager. No, Karen. You can't speak with my manager right now, he's busy. What's he doing? It's simple stuff. I get the car and take it on the selfie. How the hell? Right. I don't know where I was going with that. Well, that went, started good, then went straight onto the floor. Yeah. This is the car who's on a boat. Currently, yeah, that's it. We're currently taking this car back to South Beach. Simple stuff. I get the car and take it back to South Beach. Off. Stupid game. Had to think the last 2 hours has been spent in two films. Most notably, this one spent like the last hour.
Rolling.
Holy crap.
Action. Through the cafe.
Through the cafe. Oh, no you don't. Okay, maybe you do. I quit as a stuntman. I quit. Come on. How hard can it be to take a friggin' jet down? The worst thing is that the time limit gets squeezed. As you get close to the end of this mission, this scene, there's actually a particular time limit that gets shorter and shorter and shorter. So you really are racing. You really are racing against the clock on this one. They tell you that at the start, anyway. Oh Christ.
Cut. You wrecked it.
I was like, I made it. No, I didn't. Oops. I thought I made that as well. Oh, please. Oh.
Rolling.
He's getting bored, I can tell.
Action. Through the cafe.
What the hell did I just hit? Okay, invisible collision detection is turned on for this mission, apparently.
Under the truck and out the other side.
Okay. Oh. How is this? I can't even get to the... Right. We need to get past that friggin' diving board. Because I haven't got past it yet. There's another jump I suck at.
Rolling.
God damn it. Come on, I need to get past the friggin' truck.
Through the cafe.
Right. Okay, whatever. I'll take supercar damage, that's fine. Oh my god. This thing's uncontrollable.
Under the truck and out the other side.
There you go.
Smash tables. Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board.
Nope. I bet you got through the trees in whooping first try. I didn't even go through the trees. I went round them. I haven't 100%ed this game as I've been going through, Cal, don't worry. Yeah, you can drive through it and you still pass the scene. There's a lot of... in the earlier game, you can skip a stunt or two and still pass. Holy crap, that was close. Yeah. What will speedrunners do? We find the fastest way. Excuse me, game? Why did I think that was gonna work? And who the hell hit me then? Yeah, I don't like that. There's a few where it's like through the trees, through the bushes, and it just doesn't happen.
Rolling.
Come on.
Action.
Play Stuntman, they said. It would be fun, they said. Freaking hell. What is it with this car today? Does it want to be a fucking aeroplane or what? Oh, whatever. Assistance pays off. I could never imagine speedrunning this. I've said future speedrun. Yeah, that ain't happening. I'm sorry. It'd just be me with a timer hoping I could actually finish the game in one go. At all. Or finishing the game within 3 hours. Sub 3 is my goal of it. So far, it's taken me around 3 hours.
Truck.
I'll pass, thank you.
Jump close to the diving board.
Oh! What happens?
Down the jetty after the jet. Handbrake 180.
Finally got past that bit. Oh, okay. I'm dying in a bit. Oh, I'm not gonna make this. I don't even care at this point.
Cut! You wrecked the vehicle!
Of course, the only time I actually make it past the fucking diving board is when I mess up everything else. There's one bit which actually, once you get over that jump, it's even harder. I'm not joking, this stunt haunts me. I don't like it at all. When you get near the end, you're like, oh, thank God for that.
Rolling. Action. Through the cafe.
What is it with this friggin'... I'm driving past it.
Smash tables. Cut, that was too slow.
Come on, game. Seriously. Got through four acts, now to get through the final one.
Action! Through the cafe!
Through the cafe! Oh, crap!
Under the truck and out the other side! Smash tables! Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board. Down the jetty after the jet. Handbrake 180. Jump the harbor.
Close was that? You have to get within like 2 seconds of it as well. That's the worst thing, is that the timing of that is so tight, it's ridiculous. I told you, I said before, it gets so tight towards the end as well. It's insane how tight this gets. Like, it starts off hard anyway, and after a bit you go, oh, this isn't too bad. Honestly, getting past the truck at the moment,
it's
not exactly easy. The game's not making it easy for me.
Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board.
Freaking out. Of course! Yeah, of course you would.
Oh, down the jetty after the jet.
I flipped over and I was supposed to be gone. I'm gonna try and make this if I can. No, I'm not gonna make it.
Cut! You wrecked the vehicle.
I have done, because it's a piece of shit. That's why I wrecked it. Hate this car now. I hate this stunt. I hate this car. Hate everything about this final thing.
And rolling.
Let me get it, for Christ's sake.
Through the cafe.
I'll be happy and die in peace then. That's if COVID-19 doesn't get me.
Under the truck and out the other side. Smash tables.
Right, come on.
Under the moving truck. Jump close to the diving board.
Yes.
Down the jetty after the jet. Handbrake 180.
Holy crap, the grip this thing has.
Jump the harbor. Cut, you've wrecked it.
You stupid game. What the hell? Fun fact, the flip when the main character loads twice tomorrow hits the dying ball near the end of the move is entirely improvised. Yeah, probably.
Rolling! Action! Through the cafe! Under the truck and out the other side! Tables. Under their moving truck. Jump close to the diving board. Down the jetty after the jet. Handbrake 180.
Oh, it's off. Stupid thing. Whatever. Keep going.
Jump the harbor. Cut. Get another vehicle
you
ready.
Gotta be joking. Come on. That's the closest I've gotten. It was going well until that. Oh, piss off. Bullshit physics. That was serious bullshit. I'm not having that.
Rolling. Action. Through the cafe.
Why is it with this car hitting invisible collision detections today? Come on! Oh! It could take a good hour with this, but we'll get there eventually.
Action! Through the cafe!
See, every time it's a little late like that, I have to reset. Because the car is so fragile. It's like a glass fucking house. It's like a snowflake car. It's a piece of crap. So fragile. Can't do anything with it because it gets hurt. You know what? You, I'm gonna wreck this car.
Under the truck and out the other. Rolling. Action. Through the cafe.
At this point, I have given up. I can't be arsed trying. It's the last friggin' scene in the game, and I can't be arsed trying with it. I just can't bother. So hard. So difficult. Like, Jesus Christ. I've never played a game that's more harder than this. No joke. Has to be the hardest game I've ever finished. None of the driver games are that hard. No joke. I wish I was joking. None of the driver games I've played are harder than this.
Down the jetty after the jet. Handbrake 180. Jump the harbor. The boat racks through the narrow gap through the cafe. Get close to the explosion. 5 seconds to go. Light it up. Aim for the jet. Eject. Cut.
Yes. Oh. Finally. That was hard. Friggin' hell. Not joking. Oh my god. Half an hour later. Why did that take less than half an hour? How long did that take, actually? Like, 10 minutes? 50, no, it was longer than that. 20 minutes to do this. Oh, my days. Sorry, I've got to watch this, because I can't not watch it. I'm like, oh dear. I made this look good. The camera work actually makes it look 10 times better than it actually is. Also, letting go of my acceleration on that jump helped a hell of a lot. So, thank you to Snowtato that said to let go of your acceleration on the jump. Because that helped a bit. That helped a lot. There you go. Finished.